from the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's time to wake up and let the weirdness begin.
It's the KVJ show.
To start your morning.
Kevin is the host.
And his skin pigment is whiter than Casper the Ghost.
Virginia.
Sounds like this.
Nickname Vicious Beast.
No, don't get her pissed.
It's Jason.
Talks like a spaz.
And he loves to talk about Bigfoot and stats. So get ready, here we go. You're listening to 97.9 with the KVJ show.
Well, hello and welcome to the KVJ show. Happy Monday.
Happy Monday.
How you doing today, Virginia?
I'm doing good.
You doing good?
I forgot I had to have headphones.
Oh, yeah.
Only been doing this 25 years
yeah,
with you.
Yeah, you know. Eventually one day it'll sink in.
Like, but, why can't I hear Kevin? Oh!
Yeah, it does
Dirt.
Help.
That's a Monday dummy.
It's an interesting concept there. Bird, you're doing well today?
I'm doing great.
You look great.
Thank you.
You look fantastic, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Good look popping today. Got the whole crew here. It is a full staff. Got Denny's. Got suits in there. So we are ready to do this thing. Today is the big eclipse day. It's what everybody's kind of going crazy for here on this Monday. So this thing is going off this afternoon. We're not in the, zone of totality.
Totality.
I'm glad we're talking about this because I might have forgotten and just looked up at the sun and go, oh, ooh.
No,
and don't
yeah.
look up at the sun, kids.
Who turned off the sun?
You never should stare into the sun. They do frown on that pretty much always at all times. So,
What will we see or what should we expect? Anything?
Yeah, we're going to get a good bit of coverage. I think it's like a 48 or 52% somewhere around there that we're going to get. So you're going to start seeing some stuff. You're going to notice that, okay, oh, wait, it seems a little bit darker than normal. Or just everything, the light looks a little weird.
It kind of just sounds like a great time to nap.
It does.
Could be, yeah. Yeah, they said that pretty much one out of every seven people do not care a bit about this.
But
and they are just going to sleep right through it.
Witches love it because they believe that your witchy soul gets recharged by an eclipse and that you should be like outside. Of course, don't look at it, but you should be outside letting it kind of wash over you and recharge your witchy soul.
Really? Are you going to go out there and do that?
Oh, yeah. I mean,
she is a witch.
I feel like it would only be appropriate for my people.
Well, we do have witch communities here in South Florida.
Oh, and I know.
Some of them are in Port St. Lucie, and they do not like...
They reach out to me, and they're like, yeah, yeah, it's real.
I know. I talked a lot of trash about them on one of our podcasts. They did not take kindly.
Good.
I was talking trash about just you being a witch.
You don't know that I'm not. See, didn't your voice go hoarse just now?
It did. Witch powers
just went out. Boom. Took it.
Silence him, ladies.
She doesn't need to recharge it. She's already fully charged. Look out. Yeah, the sun is going to be obscured by the moon for about 2 hours and 26 minutes. The peak for us is going to be about 3:03 p.m. today. It starts at about 1:48 p.m. at about that time. And then the maximum duration of totality, if you're so lucky, is going to be 6 minutes and 6 seconds. So a lot of hoopla for not a lot of time. But there's one thing that could derail it a bit. Some clouds are expected.
Nah. The whole thing gets blocked by clouds. All these glasses, all right. These hotel reservations,
it's a
all these
day.
Big plans. Oh, that would suck.
Yeah, so I don't think it's going to be too devastating, but you should be able to see a little bit of it. But there could be some clouds, they say, today that could affect it. There are going to be events at the Cox Science Center and Aquarium in West Palm. FAU's Astronomical Observatory's got something going on in Boca, including some of them free glasses you can get so you can look at the sun.
Yeah, I think they had the glasses at the 7-Eleven, but I don't know if they still have them.
I don't know if I would get my... solar eclipse glaring glasses from 7-Eleven.
Well, it's better than some chucklehead I heard on the radio. He said he was going to use his glasses from 10 years ago, the last eclipse.
Oh,
I'm like, oh,
yeah.
I don't know. Those probably don't weather well.
I don't know. You're talking about your eyes. They say, yeah, you can't burn out your retinas. That's why they say never stare at the sun. And
do your best to protect your eyeball.
Yeah, don't stare at it during an eclipse.
It sounds cool, but the whole idea kind of makes me nervous because just going out there like, did I look up there too long? Because there's going to be a point I'm going to want to look.
Those witches really did knock your voice out.
Yeah. I've been rehearsing for the show. I apologize to our audience. It's barely holding on.
We need to get you some juice.
I know.
The Museum of Discovery and Science in Fort Lauderdale has also got some stuff going on today as well.
Okay.
And if you're in Palm Beach and Martin counties, apparently they don't care about no stinking eclipse. There's going to be no excused absences for students to go off and view it. So if you miss, you're going to have to lose out on that work or test or whatever you're doing. St. Lucie and Okeechobee County is going to be observing. So if you get a written note from a guardian, you'll be okay and you can check it out. So there you go. So that's the big news today. Today's solar eclipse, which may turn out to be a big bag of nothing. We'll see. All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes, what do we have on our mind? Some big stuff from over the weekend. We'll break down for you coming up in a couple of minutes. And from the number one album in the country now, Beyonce, a little Texas Hold'em to start your Monday. Yeehaw.
This ain't Texas. Ain't no Hold'em. Hey. So lay our cards down, 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 down. So park your Lexus. Your keys up. Hey. Stick around, round, 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 round. Stick around. And I'll be damned if I can't slow dance with you. Come pour some sugar on me, honey, too. It's a real live boogie and a real live hold down. Don't be a hey. Come take it to the floor now. Woo! There's a tornado.
There's a tornado.
In my city.
In my city.
It's the basement.
The basement.
That ain't pretty.
Ain't pretty.
Rugged whiskey.
We're surviving.
A break of kisses, sweet redemption, passing time, yeah. Ooh, one step to the right. We headed to the dive bar, we always thought was nice. Ooh, run me to the left, then spin me in the middle, boy, I can't read your mind. This ain't Texas. I'll be damned if I cannot dance with you. Come pour some liquor on me, honey, too. It's a real live boogie and a real live hold down. Don't be a fake, come take it to the floor now.
What are you thinking about?
you on your mind here today, Jay Bird?
I always like to see if you guys are open to some of these weird possibilities.
Okay.
It's about aliens. And now, I don't know if this person's telling me the truth. They're just giving me their story. And they swear when they were younger, they saw some type of, you know, kind of like one of them prairie dogs, like a coyote, shapeshift from an alien into a coyote.
What?
Yeah. And then,
wow.
So their whole belief system is aliens are animals that shapeshift. When you see a wolf, that could be possibly be an alien just as a wolf, and it's shapeshifting, and that's what's going down. Any way you believe that to ever be possible?
I mean, shapeshifting, that's when True Blood on HBO lost me. When they started doing shapeshifting, I mean, come on.
It really is a theory, though. There are some people that go, oh, yeah. The animals are aliens and they shapeshift.
All right. March one of them in here then and prove it.
I just love people hit me up with the weirdest stories. And I mean, I wasn't there, but they're saying they had a real account.
Well, I mean, I guess it would explain why we never see aliens, but we always see stray cats.
Plus, marijuana has become very strong these days.
People be eating all kind of mushrooms, too.
We think shapeshifting is not a possibility whatsoever.
It's not, but mushrooms are. I got soccer moms eating mushrooms over by me, so I don't know. It's different.
I'll tell you what, though. I did go down a rabbit hole of aliens and shapeshifting animals. It's fascinating.
It is fascinating. And yeah, you just like wrap your brain around that, like, yeah, maybe that's why we never see the aliens. They turn into a sewer rat.
Well, that's how the person sounded. They didn't sound like they were lying and they were making it up. So you go, are they a great actor? Are they on drugs? Or do they really have an experience?
Or are they messing with you?
Or are they, that's possible too.
They could have an agenda.
But that's what I mean. Are they a great actor messing with me? Which maybe they are.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. People love to mess with me.
They do love to mess with you. I think for some people it's sport.
I try to keep an open mind to things. Shapeshifting, I think we're taking that off the list.
Okay. What you got on your mind today, Virginia?
Well, the capybara. Do you know what this little guy is?
Capybara.
He's a little animal.
Okay.
And all over like TikTok and YouTube.
Okay.
People are domesticating the capybara. And now he's like a pet.
He's cute.
He's adorable. But I mean, if you go look on TikTok or you go look on YouTube, just search hashtag capybara. And they're so adorable. They love to eat fast food. They're very loyal.
Huh.
They're super sweet. They kind of look like a cross between like a gopher and a chihuahua. But apparently they're very sweet and loyal and
loving. I wouldn't know
loving.
What it is until you said that, but that's a good description of what that animal looks like. And I've seen them. They are adorable looking, but it's one of those things that they look adorable, but then you wonder if you got close to it, would it not claw your face off?
It's got that vibe to it.
Yeah, I don't know. Some of those animals, I'm like, okay, I don't know. It's like nature gave you this ability to be so cute just so you could scratch out my eyeballs.
Araka was trying to tell me, too, that the capybara is hypoallergenic. So if we get one, I'm not going to be allergic to it.
Oh, boy.
Oh, he was bringing all the heat.
The hard heat of the capybara.
So I guess the family is in order for getting one of these things. For real.
If Rocco was in charge of finances, we'd already have 3 capybaras.
You're right, though. Even like a koala bear, they look so sweet. I want to hug it, but I feel like it would just rip your face off, possibly.
I think they are kind of mean. I remember one time I got kind of a VIP little tour thing of the Columbus Zoo, and we got to get into the koala cage.
Oh.
And we were there getting a photo, and the koala was in the tree right behind us. And I don't know if they were messing with us, but they're saying, yeah, hey, watch, they may start growling, and if they do, you need to back away because they're very territorial and... Yeah, they're kind of deceptive in their looks.
They're cute in the face, but don't ignore the claw.
Yes.
If you look down at their little foot or hand, whatever that thing is, it is a claw with talons.
They're adorably murderous.
Yes. It's kind of no joke. So you got to be a little bit careful.
It's Mother Nature's trick.
Yeah.
Making a little thing look so cute, but it could seriously slice your face open in 2 seconds.
Mm-hmm. I want what Rocco wants. That thing is adorable.
So I've been reading up on the capybara. You shouldn't get just one because they're very social. You got to get two so they have a friend.
All right, I can get that.
Double the money, double the expense.
Oh, I want to hug them so bad.
They are apparently very loving and sweet and cuddly. They love French fries. They're herbivores. They don't like meat.
Okay.
I want one.
I know.
So
I
you just
too.
Need a few plants and they're good, huh?
I think they have special food that you feed them, but yeah.
Do you keep it in a cage or does it chill and walk around like a dog?
The ones that I've seen, it chill and walk around.
Huh. That's just it, huh?
They walk around the house. Generally not considered dangerous at all. They're known for their gentle and social nature.
Are they happy to be in the house? Or is it going to be one of them things where,
I mean,
oh my
wouldn't
gosh.
You be if they were getting French fries and chilling?
Animals love French fries. I'm sorry. It's a fact. They just do. I've seen so many animals love French fries.
People too.
Yeah.
French fries bring us together.
Yeah, they do. What I got on my mind today on Friday, I always like to drop some new music on you. And I did on Friday. And I was a little bit excited after I got an initial taste of the new Black Keys album. It's known as Ohio Players. And I got to spend some time with it over the weekend. Oh my gosh, it is so good.
Really?
It is so good. I can't remember the last time I listened to an entire album all the way through, but I was like, you know what, I'm going to start on track one. I'm going to go until there's something like, I'm not really feeling, then I'll probably slow down on it a bit. I just kept going and going and going, and I listened to the whole album probably 4 separate times.
Wow.
Over the weekend, and yeah, the songs are slightly a little bit different. But I loved every single one of them.
Look at you.
Yeah. So if you like that kind of style, here's a brief taste of some of the Black Keys if you missed it on Friday. To me, it might be one of the best alternative/rock albums that I've heard in a very long time.
Don't you love when that happens?
I do.
I've got 3 or 4 of my favorite artists that all came out with new music, and it was all awesome.
Yeah.
And I love when that happens.
That's why I get so excited for Friday, so I'm so optimistically hopeful that they're going to be dropping some new music on you. It's great, but this is an album that goes pretty deep, and every single track I thought was really good. I added them all to my playlist, and ready to go. They can ride this thing for a while.
There's a couple songs in there that sound like movie songs.
Yeah, they've kind of done that. That might be the only knock on it. They had done an album that I liked. The last project they did, it was very bluesy. And it was not very commercial.
Okay.
And it was slow. And you'd be like, okay, I don't know. This has to be a thing that you're kind of into. And I kind of respected it. But I think they said, okay, you let us take one album where we kind of did our own thing and explore, and we're going to come back with all the... They have done several songs that are in movies, and so they write that kind of sound.
Well, the critics will say, if you don't change up your sound, they only do the same sound. If you change up your sound, they're trying to be something different. It sounds terrible.
So they gave you a whole album of pop bangers. So people are going to criticize them for not taking any chances,
exactly.
And I guess that's what they do. Their next album will probably not be... You know, anything like this. But it's really good if you do like that.
Kevin liked it.
I did. I do. If you like that style of music, and if you're a fan of the Black Keys, I think you'll be a fan of this new album. All right, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, Jaybird with a very interesting weekend. Which one of these things did not happen to him, though, over the weekend? Did producer Danny's baby, Lachlan, take a poo on the bird?
Oh, boy.
Did somebody who works at a Wawa gas station reach out to him to apologize for something? Did he find 2 dead birds in his yard on 2 different days? Did somebody random in a deli line start telling him about her dead neighbor? or did he download 5 Justin Bieber songs? Wow, he's now a Belieber. Okay. What are you thinking, Virginia, if you had to guess, is what did and did not happen to the bird?
Only one of those did not happen. 4 of them did.
Okay. What do you think? Which one could it possibly be? You had to guess.
I guess I don't want it to be the dead birds. That's kind of weird.
That is disturbing.
Creepy.
Yeah.
What's going on over there that animals are dropping dead all around you?
Okay. All right. So Virginia's going to put in for that one. And I will put in that it is the 5 Justin Bieber songs.
Okay. All right.
I'll just put that one out there and we'll see where this thing goes coming up next.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
You know, I am one of those people that always needs to stay connected. And if you don't think that you can, you need to check into Xfinity's mobile hotspot. You can get yourself a Now Wi-Fi Pass. It's just $10 for 30 days. You know, sometimes you need fast internet, no matter where you are. And that's why this thing is going to be absolutely perfect for you. You can connect in seconds now with the Now Wi-Fi Pass to over 22 million Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspots nationwide. And you don't need any additional equipment. And there are no commitments and no cancellation fees. Now that's convenient. And now through April 24th, you can get 30 days of Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot access and unlimited data for only $10 with no commitments and no cancellation fees. Just go to Xfinity.com Wi-Fi Pass to find a hotspot today. Restrictions apply. Not available in all areas. After promo, regular rates apply. Currently $20 for 30 days. Pricing subject to change. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
This old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors. It helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in 3 washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
Macy's VIP sale is here. Use your coupon or Macy's card and take an extra 30% off the latest spring looks from top designer brands. Plus, get 15% off go-to beauty, skincare, and fragrances. Macy's Star Rewards members earn on every purchase, except gift cards, services, and fees. More at Macy's.com/StarRewards. Savings off regular sale and clearance prices. Exclusions apply.
If you're looking for the most epic place on Earth, let's start at the base of a massive waterfall. Then trek through the thick jungle. Then climb to the peak of a snowy mountaintop. Then once you get there, keep going. Because with intelligent 4x4 and 7 drive modes and a Nissan Pathfinder, the search is the real adventure.
Available feature. Intelligent 4x4 cannot prevent collisions or provide enhanced traction in all conditions. Always monitor traffic and weather conditions.
Hamilton is coming. Get tickets today for the Tony, Olivier, Grammy, and Pulitzer Prize winning musical. It's the story of America then, told by America. Now, Hamilton in West Palm Beach at the Kravis Center from April 10th to 21st. Get tickets at Kravis.org.
We pay the max. We pay the max. We pay the max. Let auto buy. Pay you the max. You're on your way to big fat stacks. We pay the max. We pay the max.
Get the max for your pre-owned car, truck, or SUV. Go to WePayTheMax.com.
Another happy SafeLight customer.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
There I was driving down the highway when out of nowhere, a rock hits my windshield. Ah, so annoying. But then I remembered SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace. I booked my appointment at SafeLight.com. And with my insurance, my new windshield was no cost to me. SafeLight even handled my insurance claim, which was the best.
Cracked windshield? Just go to SafeLight.com and let SafeLight take care of everything.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
That's all the groceries.
What's that?
I think it's coming from the lottery tickets.
Is that normal?
I don't know, but Gold Rush Legacy and Florida Lotto games now offer Cash Castle bonus play. Cash Castle. We could win a trip to an Irish castle and up to $1 million in cash.
Oh, one more time then.
Cash Castle.
Learn more at floridalottery.com/cashcastle. Limited time only. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
No way. Boiled Tropicana's open till midnight?
What? Grab me a Tropi Chop.
Done.
Ah, forgot the cheesy yuca bites.
Got it.
Good looking out, bro.
I didn't say they're for you, though.
Boiled Tropicana. Real food, real fresh, and now real late. Open till midnight. Hours may vary by location.
Hi, I'm Chef Justin Timoneri, Florida's culinary ambassador. If you've enjoyed preparing fresh from Florida recipes, then you're going to love the Fresh from Florida Club. As a member, you'll be able to search and save delicious recipes, create custom menus, and ask me your cooking questions. Each month, you'll also get a list of what's in season, so you can make your family the freshest meals possible. It's free and easy to sign up. And best of all, you'll be supporting Florida's farmers, ranchers, and fishermen. Join the club at freshfromflorida.com today.
When you excavate for a living, safe digging helps you keep living and save money, time, and your reputation, which can all help you breathe easier. Safety is in your hands. Every dig, every time. Always visit sunshine811.com or call 811.
Victim of a slip and fall? It takes one phone call to take back control of your life. Anajar and Levine will fight to get you the compensation you deserve. Call me, Mark Anajar, for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In Office, West Palm Beach.
They keep it real. The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Okay, so which one of these things did not happen to Jay Bird from over the weekend? Was it that producer Denny's baby Lachlan took a poo on him? Was it that somebody who works at a Wawa gas station reached out to him and apologized to him for something? Did he find two dead birds in his yard on two different days? Did somebody random in a deli line start telling him about her dead neighbor, or did he download five Justin Bieber songs? Okay, I'm going to go with the Bieber songs. Virginia, you're hoping about the two dead birds, right?
Yeah, dead birds, dead neighbors. Oh, it's a man. A lot of death.
So, Bird, what is the thing that did not happen?
Kevin is right. I did not download five Justin Bieber songs.
Just didn't feel that happened.
You thought that was possible, though, didn't you, Virginia?
I did.
I might have got out a run.
Yeah, you go on weird runs.
Yeah, okay. I do.
Okay, possible. Okay, so tell me about this. You did find two dead birds in your yard on two different days?
Yeah, Virginia's right. There is something weird going on in my neighborhood, and other people are finding dead birds randomly. I found that one weird crow just swimming in my pool. My next door neighbor found a dead bird in his pool. Mm. Then there's dead birds along by the canal area. It's kind of bizarre. I told you about some other dead animals I'm finding. It's all happening kind of at the same time, I feel like, and it's weird.
Nobody's messing around in there with a BB gun, are they?
If they were, they'd be doing it all over the neighborhood, and I think somebody might see that.
Yeah.
It's something where people, I've talked to multiple people about finding dead birds of recent.
Yeah, I've seen some stories that pop up on Nextdoor every now and then where there's somebody that is leaving out some kind of poison for birds. It has happened in some neighborhoods before. Unfortunately, I don't even know why you would do that, what the motivation could be. There could be something toxic in the neighborhood that could be going on.
Someone's doing that?
Yeah. I've just seen that question be asked in other neighborhoods before. What would be your reason?
Because it's
beyond me. I don't know.
It is random because at first you think it's from the power line, but you're finding them in odd places nowhere near a power line as well, and it's all recently.
Yeah, there's some odd stuff going on. I don't know if you've seen on the news, I'm talking about the fish that are kind of flipping out all the way from the Keys. They've said as far north as the Boynton Inlet.
Yeah, did you see that story?
They're swimming in circles and flipping around and flipping out.
They are flipping out, and it is weird, and they don't know why.
Yeah, they don't right now see any kind of known toxin in the water that would be causing it, but Yeah, there's some weird stuff. There might just be things like that. You don't know, man. There's a lot of stuff. And you got to wonder, too, if it's that unhealthy for animals, what are we doing?
It just
can't
looks
be
like
good for us either.
The fish look like they're losing their mind as if they, we got to get out of here.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like, I thought they said it's kind of slowly moving north.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, yeah. It could be a random thing going on with them birds, or who knows? Could be something else. Denny's baby took a poo on you?
Yeah, I think baby's just crap. I love holding baby Lachlan.
Yeah, cute kid.
He's a cute kid.
When Rocco was little, my mom gave him, when he was like, I don't know, maybe like 10 months old, she gave him spicy New Orleans sausage. He loved it. As a baby, loved it, but then proceeded to explode over multiple people in the family.
Wow. Yeah, diapers don't always work either that great.
There's some things that a diaper can't hold.
That's what I'm saying.
If you give a baby sausage, it's not going to be held in the diaper.
Look, that means the baby's regular, very healthy, love it.
Somebody at a deli line started randomly telling you about her dead neighbor.
Yeah, I had my Furby hat on, which is just kind of, hey, look at me, talk to me.
Yeah, okay.
Let's have a conversation. And the deli line was super long.
It's a hat that says, I'm crazy too.
Yes, it is. Right. And I had an alien shirt on. This person felt comfortable approaching me.
Yes. And what do I have to lose?
They were not in KVJ Nation. This was just a random person.
Yeah.
And she just started telling me about, you know, her day. And we started talking. And then she was telling me about, you know, her neighbor's dead, and it's just, it's weird. Yeah, I'm like, all right.
Sounds fun.
Yeah. Very open, very honest.
That's why I stopped wearing Furby hats.
I get it.
Yeah.
If you wear a Furby hat, people are definitely going to talk to you.
Yeah, they are.
I don't mind it, though.
Okay, I know. You love it. And somebody who works at a Wawa gas station reached out to you by apologizing about something.
Someone sent me a long email apologizing, saying, hey, man, I'm sorry you had a bad Wawa experience.
Those subs you talked about, you got for delivery, right? They just weren't right.
I ordered them at 9 o'clock at night from a gas station. What could go wrong? And I just said that they weren't very good.
But Wawa takes great pride in those. I think they even call them hoagies or grinders or whatever the heck you call them.
They do. And some foods, I think, don't travel great, especially from maybe a gas station.
If you got something wet on it, yeah, it's going to start permeating the bread. Could be a problem.
And I live in Palm Beach Gardens, and I think the closest Wawa to me is off, like, in West Palm. So that's kind of a good drive.
Mm.
So, you know, I wouldn't say they travel well.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, lesson learned.
Lesson learned.
They may be great when you get them there while you're filling up your tank, but not good for food delivery.
There's one on Blue Heron, too.
Okay, that's probably where it's from. Yeah. They're very nice, very kind. So thank you.
And I think we got a bonus something to talk about from Jaybird's weekend, buying stolen property in a parking lot. Now, were you with the snack pack? Did I see from the city?
Was with the snack pack.
Huh.
When you hang out with a guy named Klepto, sometimes things go sideways.
It is funny. Klepto was the one that kind of facilitated this deal.
Yeah.
But he went on this the Facebook marketplace. I needed a tricycle, but I wanted one very cheap. It's for our snack pack show at Virginia's Crawfish Festival on stage.
Yeah.
But I don't want to spend no money. And he goes, look, I know how to get the deals.
He does get some
really
deals.
Does.
That man is a masterful negotiator.
Mm-hmm.
So he hits this person up on Facebook Marketplace, and they immediately hit him up. And then they kept hitting him up. And then they kept hitting him up. Almost kind of like they had
to get rid of something. Burn a hole in their pocket.
It was weird because the game kept changing. Like, we are in Jupiter. Like, oh, cool, we'll meet you. Then they go, we're in West Palm.
What?
No.
They had to keep moving because the feds were closing in.
Were they on the tricycle?
Then they go, it's $30. Like, all right, great. It's $50.
What?
The price started to keep changing.
Oh, okay.
So I ended up saying, no, we're going to meet at the liquor store by my house.
Perfect.
Yes, okay. And
kill two birds with one stone.
And right. I brought a crew of five with me, just in case, because it felt off.
Look, numbers are in your favor when you're meeting a stranger to do a transaction that involves cash and somebody you've never met before. I think it's smart. Roll up with a crew.
And then I looked around and I go, oh my gosh, my crew looks more suspicious than anybody that could be possibly pulling in here. We're in the parking lot just hanging out.
But you have numbers.
We look like we are up to no good casing the entire parking lot, is what I'm saying. We look so sketchy. So two dudes roll up. They are very nice.
Okay.
But
a lot of crooks are.
I just feel like there might be a store. I don't know, because when I put the video up, people started hitting me up saying, hey, man, there's a tricycle that was stolen up in Port St. Lucie. Are you sure this isn't it? I go, I don't know.
You bought a stolen tricycle?
I don't know. The video is up on our YouTube shorts. Okay. Let me know if you're missing a tricycle. If it's, I'll give it back. I got it at a very good deal.
Well, we're going to use it on Saturday, and then we'll give it back.
Exactly. But we kind of...
You just kind of have to sit tight for a few
days.
That's
right. You'll get your stolen material back.
You will roll again, but just not till after Saturday.
It was two dudes, and they pulled in kind of erratically, and as they pulled in, you see the tricycle kind of jump up and down and smash into the road, kind of.
What?
Yeah, they tied it up, they hit the corner, and I saw them actually damage it in real time and still bought it. Yeah, I think something, I don't know. The whole thing was squirrely.
How much did it end up costing you?
40 bucks.
40, okay.
No, 50 bucks. I apologize. 50. It was 50, yeah. We changed from 30 to 50.
That's weird, because if it started at 30, I would be very, very insistent on keeping it at 30.
That's what was odd. And then, oh, we're in Jupiter. We're in West Palm. We're going to meet you right now.
We got stolen goods.
We want to meet you right now. They hit us up so much going, all right, what is going on
here? They had a sucker on the hook.
That's sketch.
Yeah.
But they were so nice, though.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, I've met some great thieves.
Yeah.
But I'm going to feel bad if it's what if they're not? What if it's not stolen?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
If it's not stolen, they're still price baiting you. If they post something for 30 bucks and then you end up paying 50 for it, that is slippery and shady in any book.
It was just funny. Everything just kind of, they kept throwing audibles, it seemed like.
Okay. All right. Well, this Saturday you can see the snack pack and maybe this stolen adult tricycle on stage.
Oh, it'll be there.
Yeah.
If you lost a tricycle, maybe come to the show. We'll facilitate getting it to you right after the performance.
Bring the police with you.
Jaybird goes on at 5 p.m.
Yeah.
Well, I bought the tricycle because I can't really walk right now, so the whole thing's a mess.
Yeah. Downtown Abaco in Jupiter. You can check it out. And here's one of the early classics from the snack pack, Flat Top Cop.
Flat top, flat top cop. Flat top, flat top cop. Flat top, flat top cop. Watch out for snack pack.
The shorter the hair, the meaner the cop. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top. Look at that cop, his head's shaped like a box. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top.
We break the law,
there's no denying it's true.
But the worst crime of them all
is that flat top hairdo.
Hey Mr. Policeman,
are you aware
that your cranium
is shaped like a square?
You think that you're tough
with your flat top and gun.
You look like you fought the barber,
and the barber won.
The shorter the hair, the meaner the cop. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top. Look at that cop, his head's shaped like a box. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top.
Flat top cops are mean to the core.
You remind me of the Russian jerk from Rocky IV.
We got pulled over
by a state trooper,
and he looked like Biff
from Back to the Future.
McFly, yo, Value Meal Killer.
Uh-huh.
Why you shaking?
'Cause I see a square head and I smell bacon.
Oh. The shorter the hair, the meaner the cop. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top. Look at that cop, his head's shaped like a box. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top.
Blockhead, blockhead, you're a blockhead, blockhead. You're a blockhead, blockhead.
Got a flat top.
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 The shorter the hair, the meaner the cop. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top. Look at that cop, his head's shaped like a box. Oh no, officer friendly's got a flat top.
Yeah, baby, just one of the many fun songs you're going to hear coming up on Saturday, 5 p.m. on the stage. downtown Abacoa. It is the Crawfish Festival going on. There's all kinds of great food to take advantage of if you love that New Orleans style affair.
Triple the food of last year, Kevin.
Really? Whoa. Triple the food?
Now the festival is not just in the same space. It's also going down Main Street.
Whoa. More it's booming,
food.
Huh?
What's that one dish everyone was talking about? The parfait or crawfish parkour?
Crawfish parkour.
Beignet?
No, there was
etouffee.
Etouffee.
That's what it is. Is that back?
My sister Maggie is making the etouffee.
Oh, that was amazing.
Yep. She gets here on Thursday, and that hooker is going right in the kitchen because she's going to start whipping it up from scratch. She don't play.
People were loving that.
I know. We gave some to Kevin, and
oh, my gosh.
Kevin looked like he just had, like, googly eyes.
Couldn't even believe it. Couldn't even believe it. And I love New Orleans food. It's just some of the best, man. If I ever go crazy and off a diet, I get to New Orleans, and you just go nuts on that stuff. I love all of it. And I never thought I'd find a new favorite, and etouffee, without a doubt, is my favorite New Orleans food now. It was just buttery delicious.
And you can get it, too, keto-friendly. So normally etouffee has rice in it, just like my gumbo.
I did it. It was still good.
You can get it without the rice, and then Kevin stays in ketosis, and then everything in the world is right.
It was beautiful. It was beautiful. I can't wait. I'm drooling now thinking about it.
Nice.
So if you had a big old plate of crawfish, just straight up crawfish, that's keto-friendly?
Yeah. I go for that. I love it. Yeah, crawfish is good. I love the seasonings. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I do. My wife and I go, and I know it's a little variation off, but the closest I can get is some of them boiled that they got around here with the seafood stuff. And man, if there is any huge need, I know they got one in Fort Lauderdale. We need more Cajun places that just have authentic Cajun food.
I agree. Voodoo Bayou does pretty good.
They do really good stuff. Yep.
They do excellent.
And they're right down there in Los Olas and Lauderdale, and they're also downtown at the Gardens.
Yeah.
And both locations, fantastic food. True.
People are asking, is the snack pack going to do that battle rap we did against crawfish? I said, no, we're not doing that. it doesn't feel right. Hashtag
taunting the exact.
Hashtag be cool.
Taunting the exact festival you're at.
Well, when a crawfish signs your check, you don't want to make him mad at his own festival.
It's true.
On Monday, you can go back to dissing him.
Yeah, and there are people there that just love the crawfish, and you're ripping the crawfish.
It ain't right.
Yeah.
It's right.
There'll be plenty of other stuff there, though, that doesn't have seafood in it, too, for you, Jay Byrne.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I did Tortuga. Kind of.
You did.
What a bunch of
did you stand on the other side of the fence and listen?
I did.
Ah! Oh my gosh. You're that old man?
I am that old man.
You're that cheapskate?
I am that cheapskate that did it.
Oh, Kevin.
We went down there and we started bar hopping on Saturday in Lauderdale. By the way, the weather just this whole weekend was absolutely amazing.
It was to die for. This is the weather of my dreams.
It was unreal. And so we were, you know, kind of doing that action and bar. We just, you know, a lot of times we like taking it loose. Sometimes when you're locked into a ticket, and the big problem I have with Tortuga is the price, man. All these concerts are crazy. The general admission was $150 to get in. So
Per ticket. So you're talking about $300 for you and the Queen. Did you have your son with you?
No.
Okay.
Just the two of us. So it would have been $300.
Plus probably handling charges and fees.
Yeah, and all those little things that kind of go into it. And there was really only admittedly one band that we really felt like paying for it. And so you're paying $300 to watch one band.
And you're not even getting in the good section.
Right.
That's general admission.
Let me show you. This is the band I wanted to see, Old Dominion, when they were on stage on Fort Lauderdale Beach at Tortuga. And if you're watching KVJ-TV on YouTube, you can see what I would have been standing in and how far away from the stage you would have been. There was a lot of stuff going on there. And the thing that I heard, too, what was really tough was if anybody had to go to the bathroom, the porta potty situation was a little challenging.
Oh.
And people were saying, you know, just get the VIP, man. Just get the VIP. $780.
$780?
Yeah, so I'm $1,500. I'm like, no. That's insane. I'm like, I don't know what you guys do for a living, but $1,500. Yeah, that's not just a flippant thing that I do.
Yeah, get the $780.
Yeah.
Cheapskate.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, so honestly, everything really kind of worked out well. The way I like it, at least, this is just how I roll. We were doing a little bit of a bar hopping and did kind of the usuals, did the wharf, and then went over to YOLO. By the way, saw Kristen and Ryan, a couple KVJ Nationers over there.
Nice.
And hung out with them for a little bit and then kind of hit some of the strip. And they've got the golf golf carts rolling all up and down Fort Lauderdale now. It's so handy and it's so easy. It was $10 a person to get a ride. And if you don't know, from where we were at that one end of Los Olas down to where the beach is, it was about like 2.5-3 miles.
Okay.
So $10 a person on a golf cart, it wasn't that bad. And we got there and there was a bus for a bench right outside of the venue. And we,
you sat at a bus stop.
We sat at a bus stop bench and we listened to the band. And here's what it sounded like. How bad is this? This is Old Dominion at Tortuga from my vantage point.
The bus stop.
The bus stop.
Like Forrest Gump.
This is from the bus stop outside of Tortuga. Screens I had, so I got to see the performance, and I paid no money.
I bet it sounded better in person than from the phone.
Yeah, I didn't think it was that, you know, I mean, honestly, I was probably 50 to 100 yards behind where the VIP was. So that was about it. But you know what? Again, that versus $1,500.
I say Kevin Ralston won on that
one. I definitely did the cheap man approach. And I know a lot of people would say, man, I was getting ripped apart by people. Like, hey, you never showed up to Tortuga. I'm like, oh, but I did.
Oh, I was there. Did you see that guy peeping over the fence? That was me.
It's very impressive, I think.
Like a creeper from Home Improvement.
Well, you know what was awesome? Because we sat there in B Ocean, if you don't know. The hotel is kind of right there. And they had a bar right inside. They had air-conditioned bathrooms that were clean and nice. And so we had access to the bathrooms. I had a bar right there. And I'm sitting there looking at the people that are about maybe 30 yards away from me in the VIP. I'm like, going, suckers.
I won.
All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes, Suits has got a little movie review for you. He watched Dumb and Dumber. Now, this is a movie I haven't seen in a while, but I remember being one of my favorite movies from the 90s. Thought it was absolutely hysterical.
This is Panda's favorite.
Oh, wow.
Loves Dumb and Dumber.
Okay, the big question, does it hold up through the eyes of Gen Z? We will find out next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
It's Subaru Loves the Earth Month. This continued commitment to protecting the planet is just one of the reasons why Subaru is more than a car company. Visit SchumacherSubaru.com to learn about how they are taking action in our community to help save the sea turtles. At the moment, no major incidents being reported on your roadways 95 and the turnpike up to speed for the most part throughout Broward and Palm Beach counties. Traffic, a service of Massage Envy. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
In the Palm Beaches, our backyard is filled with miracles of nature, from watching sea turtles hatch to teeming coral reefs. So go ahead, paddle, snorkel, bike, hike, or birdwatch. The best way to preserve our beaches, trails, and waterways is to enjoy them responsibly. To learn more, visit thepalmbeaches.com/sea-to-preserve. That's S-E-A to preserve. Share what you discover in our natural areas with #LoveThePalmBeaches.
Hey, it's Suits, and Wendy's has another sweet reason to get out of bed. Their new Cinnabon Pull Apart is here to satisfy your morning cravings with all the bakery-inspired flavors you love from Cinnabon, like sweet, warm cinnamon sugar rolled dough, the perfect ooey-gooey texture, and that signature cream cheese frosting. And now you can pair it with a small vanilla frosty cream cold brew for $5. Get the best part in every single bite when you choose wisely. Choose Wendy's new Cinnabon Pull Apart. Limited time only. U.S. price and participation may vary.
Having one of those weeks? Take a break and book some me time at Massage Envy. Book your next massage, facial, or stretch at MassageEnvy.com. Massage Envy, where better begins. Massage Envy is always hiring licensed massage therapists and estheticians.
If you've got a clog that just won't unclog, Art can fix it. Call the drain experts at Art Rooter Sewer Drain. Same day service, and Art will clear your main drain today for only $93, or it's free.
ArtCanFixIt.com.
If your home was built before 1975, your cast iron pipes may be failing. Art Rooter Sewer Drain restores your pipes fast with trenchless pipe relining. No excavation, big savings, and a 50-year warranty. ArtAndFix.com.
So, you finally have some time to yourself. Even if it is just the car ride home, it's you time. And look at you. Do not disturb set before you even got in the car? Impressive. You've earned this moment to just chill and drive. This break is brought to you by Target Zero and the Florida Department of Transportation.
When you do what I did, you're just going to have peace of mind going into hurricane season. Hey, it's Virginia. You know, I fortified my home. Finally, I got the project done. It took me 3 years to do it. But that's the great thing about BNT Windows and Doors. I didn't have all the money up front. They let me break it up into phases. That made it easier on the budget. And now, here we are, completely fortified. And this will be my second hurricane season without the fear of a window is going to blow out in a storm. I've done everything I can. I have prepared my home. I have done the best by my family and my things and my home. Do it with BNT like I did. BNT is so on point. Master installers. They use that custom PGT product, and PGT just makes the best-selling window and door on the market. So you've got the best installers from BNT, and then you've got this fantastic window from PGT. Go online today. BNTWindowsAndDoors.com.
Auto Accident, Gordon and Partners, 561-333-3333.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
The spring sale event has already started at hgregg.com. Used cars from $64.97. This is the best time of the year to upgrade your car. Drive your new car today. Don't wait. Visit hgregg.com now. hgregg.com.
Great viewing for the partial eclipse this afternoon. We'll see partly sunny skies, daytime highs in the upper 70s with an easterly wind. Tonight, overnight lows dropping down to about 70 degrees. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Reese Windows and Doors.
If you want your windows there in weeks, pick up the phone and just text Reese.
Win $15,000 in new impact windows from Reese Windows. Pick up your phone, text the word happy to 20129. That's happy to 20129.
What you need to know on the KVJ show.
You need to know that we have got Taylor Swift tickets. And starting today, this is your path to getting them. Now, if you know Taylor Swift, all of her Swifty fans, they love to hand out these friendship bracelets. Well, what we're going to be doing is a fun little game where you have to decode what is the phrase on the friendship bracelet to get these tickets to go see her at Hard Rock Stadium here in South Florida on Saturday, October 19th. Now, we're going to drop a clue as to what is the phrase on this friendship bracelet. You got five different times every single weekday, 9 and 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m. So we will be dropping the first clue at 9 a.m. this morning, your secret to getting these Taylor Swift tickets. Over the weekend, that Godzilla movie is doing really well. I did not realize that Godzilla movies were this big, but they keep making them, and they keep making money. Apparently, the Godzilla vs. Kong, or I don't even know what you call it. It's Godzilla X Kong. I am so unplugged from this thing, but I probably need to plug in because I think last week it was, well, like 80 million, something like that it made, and now it's 31.7 million. It's raking in some money. Dang. Number one at the box office again.
Well, it's a popular franchise. It's been around forever.
Yeah. I mean, you think about it, before I was even on this planet, they were making Godzilla movies.
I mean, it's kind of like the Barbie movie from a certain point of view.
Yeah. Guess you're right. People love big, tall lizards, so it's doing very well. But if you prefer old classics, we have Suits do a review of an old classic to see if it's worth going back and watching it again. Sometimes they are. Sometimes, oof, they are not. Dumb and Dumber, one of my favorite movies from the 90s. Regina, you said your husband Panda. This is one of his favorites as well.
My husband loves this movie.
Jim Carrey, Jeff Daniels. Thought, wow, I always am quoting lines from that movie and scenes you still hear. Suits,
You typically don't like some of the older comedies. What did you think of Dumb and Dumber?
I was hopeful because it was a 90s comedy, but honestly, the reason I haven't watched this movie before is because I just thought it would be too dumb, which the name suggests, obviously.
Yes.
And sometimes Jim Carrey can be a little over the top. Like, I like Bruce Almighty Jim Carrey.
Okay.
The Mask Jim Carrey, a little too much.
Okay. I'm with Suits on that.
Yeah,
I like a toned down Jim Carrey. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. So I was always a little weary of watching this movie, but it just popped up on one of the streaming apps that I had. So I'm like, all right, let me check this thing out. And I think I've seen bits and pieces of it before because a little bit of it looked familiar.
Mm.
It's not as bad as I thought it would be, but it's still not exactly what I would consider a great comedy.
Okay.
There are some moments where I was like, okay, this is making me laugh. I mean, yeah. Jeff Daniels has some good moments in that. There's definitely some scenes that I can see the staying power to, but overall, would I want to go back and watch that on my free time? I don't know if I would put it in that caliber.
Suits, you don't like the old comedies, man.
Yeah, he does not.
Wow. Suits is too much of like a 49-year-old man. You're an accountant. You don't have time for silliness.
It does seem like the dramas age way better than the comedies overall.
Yeah, and it might be the style. Maybe that over the top and way goofy was something that we laughed at and liked, and younger people don't like that movie.
Well, think about it, too. Back when Jim Carrey was really popular, we didn't have social media, so you just assumed everybody loved Jim Carrey because he was popular. Mm-hmm. Not everyone loved Jim Carrey, and if you had social media back then, you would have known that not everyone loved Dumb and Dumber.
Yeah, and I think sometimes, you know, over the top isn't always bad, but you have to balance it out a little bit. And I think Bruce Almighty is the example I'll give. That movie, he has some moments where he can be over the top, but I feel like that's more balanced out than what you get where he's just over the top, Ace Ventura style. It's just too much. I'm like, I don't know. I feel like he relies too much on goofy and not as much on a plot line and good comedy.
Overall, would you say you liked it? What kind of grade would you give it?
I would say it was okay. Mm-hmm. I'd put it at like a 60.
Wow.
So it's not like, I mean, it's not a horrible movie by any means, but it's just not something where if I'm picking out a movie to watch, I'm not going to suggest Dumb and Dumber.
Okay.
It wasn't that good.
He's going to get some
pushback. I will. I know a lot of people love this movie. And don't get me wrong, it made me laugh a couple of times, but it's just not a top tier comedy movie in my mind.
I just think when we first saw Dumb and Dumber back in our day, back in my day, Shoots.
When I was one.
We had just a different ear for comedy, and I think we tolerated cheesy, hokey, silly. I think nowadays, the cheesy, hokey, like, people don't love it like we did.
There's a little more subtlety, I feel like, you need to the comedy.
All right, well, we'll see how the audience feels about this. What did you think of the original Dumb and Dumber? Not talking about the second one, the first one. Good, bad, okay. We'll give you three options on that, and we will check in with the voting here on YouTube in just a second. And we also got to check in with the voting for our All Things Awful bracket. We start with 64 of the worst things in life, and we had it down to murder versus cancer.
Oh,
Looked like cancer was going to run away with it, but there was a surprise over the weekend. I'll let you know where the voting is next.
Let me tell you. Girl, you're my little boo thing. So I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Put a little gold in the teeth and it fit good, so I took the doors out the deep, okay. I see a brother holding your seat, no beef, but I'm trying to get the noise released. Don't take my talking to your own. I can keep it chill like the Soviet young blunt. I'ma keep it real when your man long gone. If you're looking for a friend and you got the wrong song, baby girl, what's good? What's with ya? If you book tonight, that's fiction. I'm outside, no pictures. You want me, go figure. To the back, to the front. You a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. Hey, to the back, to the front. You a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. You my little boo thing. So I'll give a hoot what you do, say, girl, I know. You a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know.
my little boo thing. So I don't give a hoot what you do, say girl, I know you a little too tame. I be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know.
Okay, there is a riot going on in the KVJ-TV chat room right now because Suits was just meh. Thought Dumb and Dumber was kind of mid, as the kids in his generation say today. Okay, but what about the people on KVJ-TV? We asked, what did you think about the original Dumb and Dumber movie? Was it great, awful, or okay? 14% said it was awful. Suits is kind of like, eh, it's okay. 31% of people agree with Suits. 54% say it was great, but that's a high number of people say, eh, it's okay. So I guess Suits, I know a lot of people very upset by that review.
Oh, he's had a few reviews where people get mad. They email me personally. Go, what is Suits talking about? He's young. He doesn't like Tombstone. He doesn't know these dang Generation Z's.
Okay. Another shocking result we had over the weekend, too. They had the Final Fours going on, some exciting stuff. Iowa came up just short to South Carolina yesterday. They went up winning the women's NCAA championship. The men are playing tonight, UConn versus Purdue, in that. And we had our own All Things Awful bracket, 64 the worst things in life. Started with 64 terrible things. We narrowed it down to murder versus cancer. It looked like cancer was going to run away with it. Had 61% of the vote on Friday, and then something happened over the weekend. Come in here today, and it's tied 50-50.
What?
So the voting must continue on until the end of the show.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it's right there, split down the middle between murder and cancer.
Murder made a run for it?
It did, yes. Murder made a big comeback over the weekend. It usually does on the weekends. Murder thrives
weekends
on weekends.
Weekends are much made better for, murder. For murdering.
Weekends
yeah.
are made for murder. Yeah. All right, so keep voting, kvjshow.com. Before the end of the show, we'll announce who wins the All Things Awful bracket.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, coming up in your Dirt of the Day, I saw this picture over the weekend, and it made me feel weird. When a old dude is kissing all over a young girl, and they're celebrities and they're big name family. I don't know. Ugh, we'll get into it coming up in your dirt.
Dates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
It's Subaru Loves the Earth Month. This continued commitment to protecting the planet is just one of the reasons why Subaru is more than a car company. Visit SchumacherSubaru.com to learn about how they are taking action in our community to help save the sea turtles. At the moment, we have a major incident causing delays this morning on the Turnpike southbound. This is on the approach to Indian Town Road. All lanes blocked at the moment. Make sure to avoid that area this morning. You're also seeing northbound slowdowns through the area. Give yourself plenty of extra time this morning. Traffic a service of Massage Envy. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Having one of those weeks? Take a break and book some me time at Massage Envy. Book your next massage, facial, or stretch at MassageEnvy.com. Massage Envy, where better begins. Massage Envy is always hiring licensed massage therapists and estheticians.
Now is the time to start thinking about summer camp for your child. And if you live in Palm Beach County, did you know more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships are available for children ages 5 through 17? Want to learn if your child may be eligible for a scholarship to cover all camp costs? Go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
If you're a contractor who excavates, you can put time on the side of safe digging. Help locators save time and work efficiently by not requesting your tickets too far in advance, by giving detailed location descriptions, and by always pre-marking with white paint. Working together works better. Safety is in your hands, every dig, every time. Always visit sunshine811.com or call 811.
Diamonds Direct Spring Sale starts this weekend. Get 20% off rings, earrings, pendants, bracelets, and more. It's the best store-wide sale of the season.
Plus, book an appointment and get an additional $100 off. That's 20% off plus $100 off store-wide. And enjoy an expanded selection of the latest styles with designer appearances each weekend. Tons of engagement rings on sale, too. 20% off. Starts Friday and open Sundays. Details at DiamondsDirect.com.
Are you sick?
Yes, I've caught the travel bug. I need a vacation stat.
I heard Silver Airways has returned to PBI, flying nonstop to Pensacola, Tallahassee, Tampa, Nassau, and Marsh Harbor.
I heard that too. We can catch a flight to Pensacola to relax on the white sand beaches, or Tallahassee to see the kids.
Wow!
What about Tampa? It's been too long since we've been to the theme parks there.
How could we choose just one?
Let's book all five.
Palm Beach International Airport is South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Book now at silverairways.com.
Hey, it's Jay Bird. Are you hungry? Well, if you are, Dunkin's got you covered. Let's talk Wake Up Wrap, paired with hash browns, snack and bacon, and some stuffed bagel minis. That's how you start off a Monday, and you got to download that app. Dunkin's going to get you deals galore if you download that app. Reward points, all that great stuff. That blueberry donut me and Denny's are always gamming on about, or Rocco's favorite, the strawberry donut. I'm Jay Bird, and I run on Dunkin'.
Who lays the papers in your neighborhood and lays them really good for a really great price? Yeah, who lays the papers in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, you know it's Deck and Drive, yeah.
Well, we just love that Deck and Drive jingle. We're singing it all the time. Hey, it's Virginia. If you're a homeowner like me and you want to upgrade your pool deck, driveway, patio, and you're thinking about new pavers, then get your texting fingers ready, because if you text the word radio to 909090 right now, you're automatically entered to win $15,000 in brand new pavers for your pool deck, patio, or driveway, courtesy of Deck and Drive. No purchase necessary. It's free and so easy to enter. Just text radio to 909090 for your chance to win up to $15,000 in new pavers, courtesy of my friends at Deck and Drive.
Who lays the pavers in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, you know it's Deck and Drive, yeah.
You want subs made with high-quality meats and cheeses? You go to Jersey Mike's. You want high-quality radio ideas? You go to me. Like this. I'm an astronaut on a mission to find water on the moon. But because I'm a genius, I realize that what humanity actually needs in space is high-quality meats and cheeses from Jersey Mike's. Now to figure out how to remove the helmet and eat the sub without my head exploding. Here goes nothing. Always high-quality meats and cheeses. Jersey Mike's. A sub above.
Another happy SafeLight customer.
SafeLight Repair. Safe Light Replace.
There I was driving down the highway when out of nowhere, a rock hits my windshield. Ah, so annoying. But then I remembered, Safe Light Repair, Safe Light Replace. I booked my appointment at safelight.com. And with my insurance, my new windshield was no cost to me. Safe Light even handled my insurance claim, which was the best.
Cracked windshield? Just go to safelight.com and let Safe Light take care of everything.
Safe Light Repair, Safe Light Replace.
When it comes to all things relocation, the team at Good Greek is the best. They can take all the stress out of your move, put it on their strapping shoulders, and make your relocation painless, stress-free. Wouldn't that be great? You don't have to go around to five different vendors. They do everything: moving, storing, real estate, mortgage, finance, everything. They handle it all at Good Greek.
Yeah, they're very convenient. My daughter keeps using them because she keeps moving all over the place.
And where's she moving now?
She is moving a lot of her stuff to storage, actually, because, you know, with her new job, she doesn't necessarily need a place full time. She felt like she was wasting a lot of rent. So Good Greek is going to come and take care of the problems, and it's so convenient. We call them every time.
I love it.
Yeah, and my buddy used them for junk removal. I'm always talking about junk removal. He used them for junk removal.
Big, small, junk removal, real estate, they do it all, and they do it better than anybody. So go with the best. Go to goodgreek.com, because it's all Good Greek to us.
Experience the Anager and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, I saw the picture over the weekend, and as a parent, yeah, I was just thinking, boy, I wonder what Russell Simmons and Kimora Lee Simmons think about their 21-year-old, super gorgeous model daughter, Aoki Lee Simmons, all snuggled up, making out with this 65-year-old restaurateur that is not in great shape. I mean, the pictures just look, I don't like it. But anyway, so it was all over Page Six. It was all over my feed. And I guess Mama did not like it. Kimora Lee Simmons posted a picture of a mother panda bear holding her cub in her mouth, talking about how she may have to get involved because this is on my last nerve right now. Mm-hmm. So I don't know what that means. But Russell Simmons, who I think kind of has been on the outs a little bit with his kids and I know with Kimora, he posted unconditional love for his daughter and making sure that she knew how much he loved her. I think he took the opportunity to say, oh, you can date whoever you want, baby girl, even if your mother disapproves. I approve of everything.
Trying to get back on the good side. Yeah.
You can totally see the family dynamic and what he's doing. And
make all the mistakes you want. Go ahead.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Make out with a gross 65-year-old on the beach, and you're a smoking hot 21-year-old who could get any man she wanted. Yes, definitely make out with that gross guy. Mm. In other news, boy, I was all up in it this weekend, Jay Bird.
Yeah.
It was WrestleMania 40.
Wow. It's a big one, Kev. 40 years of just great fun.
Yeah.
So star-studded, too. I mean, The Rock, John Cena, CM Punk, The Undertaker, Lil Wayne, Jason Kelsey, Snoop Dogg. I mean,
a lot of big names. Yeah.
So many big names.
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg even got in the ring at one point in the match, filling in for somebody, dropping a Snoop elbow.
It's always my favorite because if you see a celebrity get in the ring, you know they're there to do some kind of wrestling move. They're going to get the one up on whoever is going to be there.
And they're also going to promote their new product, which, by the way, is an alcoholic beverage called Gin and Juice.
Is it?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And sometimes these celebrities that go into the ring, they don't always nail the move, which can look very awkward.
Well, Snoop nailed it.
Good.
He landed the Snoop elbow.
I knew.
Oh, he did. Okay.
On the Miz.
I knew it'd be an elbow because that's the easiest
move
to do.
Will you show me on Kevin what the Snoop elbow looks like?
I can't really walk.
Oh, damn it. Who Snoop elbowed you?
It would go terrible for Kevin and for myself.
Yeah, we're both going to wind up in the hospital.
Yeah, so that was two nights. I mean, good Lord.
Does Rocco like wrestling?
Rocco likes it, and he gets into it. He goes with his dad, but I didn't go with them. They went Saturday night to a WrestleMania party, and then I did go with them on Sunday night to the WrestleMania party. So they did back-to-back nights.
That's a lot of wrestling.
That's a lot of WrestleMania,
wow. Okay.
Kevin.
Yeah, that's a good bit.
I got some wrestling toys if Rocco wants them.
Oh, he would love them.
Okay.
You want to part with them? I know you love them.
Well, I mean,
you have enough toys?
They're my toys, Rocco.
Yeah, you're going to play nicely with your toys?
Yeah, I'm going to share with the other kids, Kevin.
Good. All right.
And finally here, I put this one in here for you, Jay Bird. I know you love The Wheel. Pat Sajak's final episode is going to air Friday, June 7th. They already taped it. They taped it this past Friday. So it's the end of an era. He has hosted Wheel of Fortune since 1981, but it is over, baby.
I'm not real pumped about Seacrest becoming the host. I'm sorry. I know some people don't like Pat. I think Pat was great.
I just don't want Seacrest.
I don't want Seacrest.
Do they have to give this clown every gig?
Does Seacrest have fans? Like, I'm talking about fans.
He's solid.
Love Seacrest.
He's not going to be controversial. He's solid. Seems like a really good human. But I mean, he's like toast. It's just boring.
Passionate fans. He does?
Yes, corporate execs.
You know he's not going to be in a scandal.
Yeah, they love him.
You know he's not going to do anything dumb. He's a hard worker. Yep. He shows up.
Give him every gig. No scandals, no problems. He's a robot.
But that's
they love him.
That's it.
And that's all that matters.
Kevin loves him because robot respects robot.
That's right, yeah. Solid robot.
And that's what's going on in your dirt.
Okay. Celebrities having a birthday today. Taylor Swift's ex. Do we like him? I don't know. Matt Healy, lead singer of The 1975.
Oh, no. We do not like him.
We don't like him.
No,
right?
Okay. Kevin. How dare you even ask?
Okay. I didn't figure. I mean, how many of Taylor's exes do we really like?
We like Taylor Lautner.
Okay, he's redeemed himself.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I don't know about Gyllenhaal, 7-minute song written about you.
Yeah. No, we don't like Gyllenhaal.
John Mayer.
Oh,
no, we don't like him.
I love John Mayer, but I don't think
Swifties.
Take guy to Mayer, man. All
right. Well, the most recent ex that we don't like is 35 today. Robin Wright, she was in Forrest Gump, Princess Bride, House of Cards. She turns 58 years old today. Got a happy ninth birthday out to Bella from Mom, Dad, Haley, and Aiden. There's her adorable photo on KVJ-TV.
Aw, so cute.
Debbie having a birthday, turning 34. They're on the road to Winter Park for a nice day trip away from Boynton Beach.
Oh, I love a day trip.
Okay, there you go. Looking for a place to eat. So if you got a great suggestion in Winter Park for lunch, Nikki from Boynton Beach would like to know. Also, we got Darielle sending this in. Our baby girl Gianna Claire turned 1 from the 772. Look how adorable she is.
Oh, what a cute shot.
And also we got Lila saying, my mom turning 43. Giselle is her name, wishing her a happy birthday. And Lori, happy birthday. That is from Samara in Massachusetts.
Happy birthday.
Got a birthday? No matter where you are, send us an email, mail@kvjshow.com, and we will give you that shout out. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, you said you're trying something a little bit different with your son Rocco's bedtime routine, Virginia?
Yeah, I kind of got it inspired by you.
Yeah?
You were reading us some stories last week, and you made me really reconsider letting him be on his smartphone before bed.
Huh. Okay, do we have any kind of results yet from this that we can talk about in a second?
Yeah, the first night didn't go so well.
Okay, all right. So maybe we're not giving out the best advice
here.
You
can see where the phone addiction is definitely taking hold of him.
Okay, all right. We'll see what the plan is and where it just fell apart coming up next.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold. Have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, 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 thunder,
thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder,
thunder. Feel the thunder.
My classes while I was scheming for the masses. Who do you think you are? Dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping in the nosebleeds.
Thunder, 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 thunder,
thunder, thunder.
something new with your 8-year-old son's bedtime routine, Virginia, and it doesn't sound like it was very successful. What exactly were you trying, and how did it fail?
Well, I think breaking a habit is always going to be hard. We just kind of at bedtime have always let him be on his phone, be on his iPad, crawl in bed and watch videos or scroll through to not TikTok. He does YouTube. But we were kind of liberal with, you know, letting him do whatever before bed. And then you were reading some stories about how it can be linked to anxiety. And he does have anxiety. Like he has to, you know, do things to deal with his anxiety. And so I last week on Thursday and Friday started it with him where, you know, when it's time for bed, we put all the electronics away. You brush your teeth, you get ready for bed, you crawl in bed and we read a story. Instead of looking at a screen. And the first night was tears and anger.
Well, what story did you read him?
Well, he didn't want to read. He wanted his phone. He wanted to do what he's been doing, which was, you know, put himself to sleep by the light of the blue phone light.
That blue light,
That blue light
supposedly wakes up your brain.
And I don't want that. I want him to relax his brain and get a little reading in and be normal and not be filled with anxiety. And so the first night went rough. Second night it was a little better. And then we did it again last night. And last night there was no tears. There was no pushback. There was no drama. He actually looked forward to it. He picked the story out himself.
How about that?
What do we go with? What story?
Good Night New Orleans. And it's all about like all like good night beignets, good night crawfish. Like it's just all the things. And he was very proud to read it, very happy to read it.
How
and
about that?
Very engaged.
Let him know Uncle Jaybird's got a suggestion for a book for him.
What you got?
Freckle Juice by Judy Blume.
Oh, I love it.
And I think he might like Judy Blume because if we kind of get him excited and jacked up about it, he might like that.
I got him a Judy Blume book when we were at the book fair not too long ago, and I'm trying to figure out how to get him into it.
Because you don't want to blow it.
I don't want to blow it.
You want him to like Judy Blume.
I loved Judy Blume growing up. Like, that was my thing. I read all the books cover to cover. I loved Ramona.
They did a really good job back at my school, back at Lake Park Elementary, of really getting kids jacked up for Judy Blume books and stories.
I think that they are so fun and funny for kids. I really hope I can get him to come to the Judy Blume side.
It's probably a good thing for a lot of parents to hear because when I played that clip last week that was talking about this, digitally detoxing your kids and the benefits of it, they said that it does take a little bit of time because your brain is hacked and it needs that stimuli. And when it's not there, it's like anyone else that's getting away from drugs or gambling, whatever your
Might be.
Yes, you jones for it. And it does take a good week, I think is what he was saying, for your brain to reset itself and not feel like it has to have that stimulation.
It is weird because you feel you put a movie on and you feel like you have to grab your phone. Something in your body, like an addiction.
Yes,
you want to do it. You're not even realizing you're doing it.
It's because they got us.
They got us.
And we have to make a conscious effort to take the path of some resistance.
Yes.
It's a harder path. But I think in the long run, after you get past the tears and the drama and the fighting, the kid will appreciate it. They'll appreciate that time that you spend together.
Yes.
They'll appreciate those moments with mom and dad where everybody's just focused on each other and togetherness.
Some of my best memories as a kid was my mom reading to me way before they had social media, but they are the fondest of memories. And one thing I've noticed with a lot of kids, I don't know how well they write today. And I think even just hearing stories and good writing, I think it starts to sink into your brain. And as you grow up, just hearing a lot of good writing it will help you become a better writer yourself.
I agree. And there's not a lot of good writing in the captions on TikTok and YouTube.
Absolutely, right.
It's actually the opposite. It's very poor grammar, poor spelling.
Mm-hmm.
It's a hot mess.
Oh, there's a movement of people saying if you try to defend writing correctly, you're an old dinosaur. The world's changing. Get used to having people just writing things wrong. Mm-hmm. Like,
No.
Okay.
No.
I don't think that's a good thing.
No.
It's not a good thing. And it makes you look dumb. When you go out in the world with your bad spelling, your bad grammar, your TikTok English,
right,
you're not going to be taken seriously in your job applications, in your pursuit, in your interviews, in all that. Don't you want to be taken seriously? Don't you want to make more money?
I think it puts a ceiling on the type of caliber job you can get.
Totally.
Mm-hmm. Right now.
There are certain jobs you would not get if you were a terrible writer.
Totally.
But what people are saying is, yeah, that's now because there's so many people that are older that want good writing. But if you are the newer generation and that's how you're kind of being brought up of writing like a TikTok, that eventually is going to become the new way if you're not careful.
Well, it's not there yet. And if you want to be able to be taken seriously and support yourself and have a great career where you actually make good money, you still have to be able to speak and write and use good English and grammar.
And professions like medicine and law and things like that, I don't know that that will change.
No.
I know you can try to say that, hey, maybe we'll just adapt because it's communication, but clear, concise communication is key in some professions.
No, we'll talk in 20 years.
If you miss,
you'll be in the woods in 20 years. You won't be talking to nobody.
I'll be happy if I'm breathing in 20 years.
If you missed it last week, here's what gave Virginia the inspiration for the bedtime stories with her son. These are the four principles for kids and tech.
One is no smartphone before high school. Just give them a flip phone or Apple Watch, smartwatch. That's what the millennials had, flip phones. They came out fine. No social media till 16, which is what the DeSantis bill does with a card
right
for
pregnant. 16.
16. No phones in school. Schools must go phone free.
Yes.
Every school that does love it, the kids love it too. Once they detox after a couple of weeks, the brain resets, they actually love it. And the fourth norm is far more independence, free play, and responsibility in the real world. Because if we're gonna reduce screen time, we have to give them something to do. We have to give them something constructive, like play with each other.
This is
okay. There you go. Pretty crazy concepts in today's world.
And if you just start implementing, you know, little things, little by little, less screen time, more other stuff, I think it's good. And we as parents, I know I've been guilty of this. That screen, man, it's a little babysitter.
Yeah, it is.
It makes my life easier. When we're out, when we're doing this, when we're doing that, when we're at home and I have dishes or laundry or dinner to cook. But it's not going to be beneficial to him in the long run to be a slave to that screen, to be grabbing that phone and checking it all day. Mm-hmm. They broke our brains, but we can take them back.
Just expect tears on night one.
Yes. And night two.
All right. Coming up here in a couple minutes, we did a draft on Friday for the best hip hop artist / MC. We'll see who voted what and who won next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
It's Subaru Loves the Earth Month. This continued commitment to protecting the planet is just one of the reasons why Subaru is more than a car company. Visit SchumacherSubaru.com to learn about how they are taking action in our community to help save the sea turtles. Major delays this morning as you're traveling into Palm Beach County. An accident has shut down all lanes on the Turnpike southbound before Indiantown Road. You're seeing about a two-hour slowdown right now. Make sure to stay off the Turnpike through there this morning. There's also a crash to watch for on 95 southbound as you're approaching Indiantown Road that is causing some fairly heavy delays. This is off to the left shoulder, but expect a 2 mile slowdown approaching that area. Traffic, a service of Massage Envy. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Having one of those weeks? Take a break and book some me time at Massage Envy. Book your next massage, facial, or stretch at MassageEnvy.com. Massage Envy, where better begins. Massage Envy is always hiring licensed massage therapists and estheticians.
when you're thinking about plastic surgery of the face, it is one of those things that you really got to do your research on. The face is something very, very precious and delicate and fragile, and you don't want to go to someone who messes up your face, because now that is what everybody sees, your messed up face. This is not the time to shop around for the cheapest surgeon. You need the best facial plastic surgeon. You need Dr. Rosenthal. He did my daughter's rhinoplasty, so gentle, she barely even bruised. I watched him do my girlfriend's beautiful lift, where she went in looking 50 and walked out looking 30. It was amazing. He's now celebrating 20 years of beautiful facial plastic surgery in Palm Beach County. Go see him for anything face, eyes, neck lift, facelift. He is the pro. Rosenthal-MD.com.
Strax Aesthetics, leader in cosmetic surgery for 20 years, offering the same great values with prestigious board-certified surgeons. For qualified patients, breast augs from $100 per month, tummy tucks from $155 per month. Great credit is not a necessity. Meet your actual surgeon in a face-to-face consultation. Gastric sleeves at the guaranteed lowest prices. Semaglutide for weight loss at 50% below other clinics' prices. Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price on products. Liquid facelifts with no downtime at highly affordable prices. For information, call 954-749. 93040 or visit straxplastics.com.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide with all the celebrity buzz. It's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex. But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs, all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
Well, I was at Berry Fresh Cafe on Saturday morning, brunching like a rock star. Oh my gosh, I love this menu. I love the way that the team at Berry Fresh does it. You know, Berry Fresh Cafe, now in Stuart, Jupiter, Port St. Lucie, and Palm Beach Gardens, they are an amazing scratch cooking kitchen. Farm to table, locally sourced ingredients, fresh, organic, beautiful ingredients. They rotate the menu seasonally, and I love that too, because right now, Florida blueberries are in season. It's the annual blueberry festival for the next 2 weeks at Berry Fresh Cafe. They get these delicious Florida blueberries from Castro Farms in Winter Haven. And today, it starts the blueberry festival at Berry Fresh Cafe. Family owned and operated, full liquor, beer, wine, mimosas. I love the berry mimosa. You're going to love it, too. Breakfast, lunch, brunch, they do it better than anybody. It's Berry Fresh Cafe.
If you're the victim of a car crash, never rush to settle with the insurance companies and never settle for just any attorney. Demand Anajar and Levine. Call 1-800-747-FREE for a free consultation and take back control of your life.
In Office West Palm Beach.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
The spring sale event has already started at hgregg.com. Used cars from $64.97. This is the best time of the year to upgrade your car. Drive your new car today. Don't wait. Visit hgregg.com now. hgregg.com.
Great viewing for the partial eclipse this afternoon. We'll see partly sunny skies. Daytime highs in the upper 70s with an easterly wind. Tonight, overnight lows dropping down to about 70 degrees. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Morgan & Morgan Injury Law Firm.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. For over 35 years, we've grown by offering our clients more offices, more lawyers, and recovering more than $20 billion. Injured? The choice is easy. Morgan & Morgan. Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Time for a Dunkin' Run, the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF. What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
Hey, we need you to subscribe to the KVJ Show's YouTube channel. We're trying to get to 30,000 subscribers. And when we do, Javer finally is going to be cutting his hair. He's been growing since the pandemic 4 years ago.
That's insane.
That is crazy.
What have I done?
It's called Lost Your Mind.
Hey, you can see that video in all its glory, the one I was talking about earlier about me buying that tricycle, that yes. Shady situation. People already put in comments saying, yeah, this whole situation looks kind of shady.
Okay, so it's up on our YouTube?
Yes.
Okay, you can go check that out.
It should also be noted that you and your crew look just as shady as the guys that sold you the possibly stolen tricycle.
Are you wearing just one slipper?
Well, I wore...
One shoe on, one shoe off?
I wore slippers, but I got on the bike to try it out, and as I was trying it, my slipper fell off.
Oh, okay.
And I couldn't bend down because of my hamstring pull, so the guy actually picked up my slipper for me and put it in my basket.
Oh, that's nice. Lord.
That's a nice slipper basket.
It was weird,
that's
man.
That's good. All right, so if you want to see that video or watch us live, you can right now. Just go to YouTube, look for the KVJ Show. Subscribe while you're there. That's what we're going for. Ring that bell to get a notification when we have got a new video posted. On Friday, we did the KVJ draft for the best hip-hop artist / MC. I had the overall number one vote, and I went with Eminem. Then for my second pick, I got Tupac and Nicki Minaj. Suits went Snoop Dogg, 50 Cent, and Drake. J-Bird got Notorious B.I.G., Busta Rhymes, and Crazy Bone from Bone Thugs and Harmony. Virginia went with Jay-Z, Eazy-E, and Cardi B, rhyming all three of her MCs.
I think I should get extra points for actually rhyming and flowing my choices.
Yeah, we'll see if that panned out for you.
You flipped it.
And then Danny's went with Dr. Dre, Ludacris, and Method Man from the Wu-Tang Clan.
I wish I would have got DMX. Now that I think about it, I love DMX.
Should have gone that way, huh?
Yeah, huge fan over there.
Okay, so Virginia, did she get points for rhyming? No.
Ooh. Oh.
She finished last with 8 votes.
Damn.
I mean, if there's ever been a message
single
sent,
digits, yeah.
Oh, single wow. digits. Yes. It's actually impressive to be that bad.
It is. It's tough to stay in that level. Yeah. That's tough. Okay, finishing next to last, it's J-Bird. With Notorious B.I.G., Busta Rhymes, and Crazy Bone.
I think I lost everybody at Crazy Bone. He's not necessarily a household name.
Okay. Finishing in third place, Suits this week finishes third with Snoop Dogg, 50 Cent, and Drake. So it's between myself and producer Denny's. And the winner is me.
Hip Hop
wow.
Kev.
Eminem, Tupac, and Nicki Minaj.
Well, look, you used to work at a hip hop radio station back in the day.
I did, yeah. I did, absolutely. Heat of the Bay, baby.
I would pay. I would try to a GoFundMe page to get audio. That, yeah.
Why is there no audio? You don't have anything from those days?
I think it used to be on cassette tape. I don't know where they might be. If I could find a cassette player, I think I do have some.
I've got a cassette player. If you've got the tape, I got the time.
Oh, okay.
I'll see if I can find them and maybe we could pull some staticky audio off of it.
I still have my very first radio station, classic rock tapes. I still have those. Like, we could look back into the yearbook of years gone by.
Oh, boy. That'd be something to hear.
I've got my broadcasting... the tryout video that you had to do
at Connecticut School of Broadcasting.
Yes, and it is dated, and I don't know if I wrote the right stuff. It was,
I don't know if they should let me graduate.
Okay, well, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, got something new to tell you. My wife threw a new high-hanging curveball right at me, and I'm not really sure how to react.
Uh-oh.
It's a brand new level, y'all. I'm going to vent and tell y'all about it next.
You said all your serious, I try, but I can't figure out. I've been next to you all night, I still don't know what you're about. You keep talking, but not much coming out your mouth.
Part of what I love about my wife is that life is not dull. There's always something that's going on. And if it were just me, pretty much everything would be very predictable. It would be very routine. You would know what was coming down the pike. Life would not throw you a lot of surprises.
You would be so straight and narrow.
Yep.
And she is just the opposite. She is the curviest of curveballs.
Yep. Never know what you're going to get. Just out of nowhere. Just, whoa, I did not see that coming. I've been with her a very, very long time, decades upon decades. And still, you're just like, okay, crazy. I didn't see that one coming. But it does. It does. And, you know, hey, you got to learn how to react on your feet, on the fly. And look, through the course of our marriage, there are a lot of times where I just have learned to bring it in, not say a word, sit on it a while, and work through it. And sometimes I've been able to win in some of those situations by not reacting with emotion immediately.
She'll wear herself down sometimes. And if you wait it out, the crazy idea will flush it out on her own without you saying anything.
Do you ever slip up and that emotional Kevin does come out? Or have you learned that it just doesn't even happen anymore?
I'm pretty good. It's very rare. And it would only come out if she's held on to it for a while. And I have to say, all right, I have to let you know, because it's past the usual time of where your harebrained ideas start to, you know, simmer down. And now it's still boiling.
Simmer down now.
I got to let you know, because I've not expressed my opinion, but here it is.
Uh-oh.
And that's usually when it happens, where after a certain amount of time that I will get a little bit more vocal and... I'll bristle up a little bit
so
more.
Is this a new idea that she just hit you with this weekend, or is this one of those things she's been working out for a while?
It's an idea I feared one day would come.
Oh my gosh. I hope it's not what I'm thinking it is. I hope it's not what I'm thinking it is. Is she going up full on face tat?
She will tell you that she's not, because it's by her ear. But dog, it's a face tat.
Oh,
it happened.
Wow.
You were fearful for this.
She said she was going to do it, but nobody believed her.
I believed her.
I did not believe her. I thought the neck thing, she'd be like, no, I'm not going to go any further up.
If you've missed the whole saga of how this began, when my daughter got into her 20s, she started doing tattoos. And my wife, when I met her, had one small little discreet rose in the bikini line. She didn't know. I was all cool with it. Fine, whatever. But I guess as a way to bond and also to remain young and youthful, she thought tattoos was the way to go. Because, hey, a lot of the young kids are getting the tattoos. Hey, not what they used to be in the day. And I get all that. But
they don't have the stigma that they used to have.
You're right. But you're still primarily seeing kids in their 20s getting them. And I do see women of my wife's age sometimes doing desperate things to try to hold on to their youth and feeling like, hey, let me try to prove to you that I still got it. Mentally, I'm a 20-year-old, even though I'm in a 40-plus-year-old body. And one tattoo led to another. My daughter started getting them. Then we're talking about sleeves, then tattoos on the hands. And I'm like, okay, I was always good as long as we had the cover-up thing going on.
But you can't hide something on your knuckles.
My wife being an educator of pre-K children, I thought tattoos might be something that could one day inhibit her ability to find work and thus our financial situation. Then my daughter was talking about getting a neck tattoo, and that's where I was like, oh no, please, let's not do it. And originally it was going to be a butterfly right on the front of the throat.
Oh my gosh.
Something that, unless you're wearing a turtleneck, which a lot of times in South Florida, you don't want to wear a turtleneck.
Amen.
And I thought, okay, this isn't going to be great. Then it became three crosses on the side of the neck. That's where it all went. And they said, hey, we can put our hair down and cover it up. Got to that, lost all that. Then I thought, okay, let's just protect ourselves from the face tat. And my daughter comes to me and she says, I want to get a tattoo of her younger brother. His name is Cannon, on the front little part of her neck in Hebrew. I'm like, okay. She's like, but I'm not going to tell mom, because I know if mom finds out that she'll want to get it as well. And I know how you feel about that. And that's just the way it goes. So I don't know what happened, but apparently a conversation was had and Caitlin did not do what she said she was going to do. And my wife said, you know what? I'm going to get that Cannon tattoo. I'm like, are we really going for the front of the throat now?
To the area on Kevin. If anybody's watching on KVJ-TV.
That you have there, that I have there, right at the base of your throat.
The base of your neck, the front facing middle.
Right above your sternum. Mm-hmm.
It's like a little hole there.
Yeah. So I think that's where Caitlin is going. And so my wife said, yeah, so, you know, we're going to get that tattoo. I was like, oh, okay. So you talked to Caitlin. She's like, yeah. But I'm going to get it right here next to my ear on the side of my jaw.
Okay.
If you know where your inner ear is.
Kind of in your sideburn.
And I said, so we're talking about a face tat now. She's like, oh, no. It's like an ear tattoo. I'm like, no. That's face. Ear starts here.
Right.
The tattoo starts there. That's face.
That's face.
That is a face tattoo. And so we couldn't even come to an agreement on semantics, which I feel like I'm right on semantics.
You are.
I'm like, now we're going into the level of face tattoo. And I'm like, well, what are we going to do? Jelly roll? Is that what we're doing? She's like, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm like, if you've not seen the artist Jelly Roll, who did a Super Bowl commercial ragging on how he doesn't necessarily love his tattoos, and oh man, if I could just do it again, I don't know that I'd have all these face tattoos.
Post Malone too. Post Malone's got that look going on too, the face tats.
Yeah, I'm like, so where are we going here with this? Like, because, you know, look, you haven't stopped yet, and I had thought, okay, I'll let one go. Then it got two, then it got three, then it was sleeves, then it's hands, then it's neck, and you know, now I guess I'm just one day going to be married to Jelly Roll or Post Malone.
Do you just accept the fact that they're going to do it anyway? Whether you state your opinion anyway, they're going to do it.
Yeah, because there's just minimal fight. But it's just, look, like I said, I'm not necessarily a tattoo guy. And if you want to have them on other parts of your body, that's fine. And that, to me, was kind of the compromise. Go on ahead. But yeah, when we're looking at the things, for me, hey, face is what makes you attracted to somebody. I'm not attracted to tattoos. So I'm just saying you are, I would expect about to go down a path where if you continue this like you have, I'm not going to find you attractive at some point.
Is that what she's going for?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know that she cares. And it just, to me, it's like, I think it's nice to be attracted to your partner. I think it's kind of critical for what's going on.
Well, you know, Panda got that neck tat, not on his face. It's below his ear, and I can still see
it. You can look at his face, and you can see the eyes and the attractiveness and whatever, and you're still there. But I think I would get to the place where the first thing I'd always notice is a tattoo, and a tattoo that I didn't really want. I'd be like, eh, okay.
I still see Panda's tattoo every time. I don't like it. I think it's too close to his face.
Yeah.
And it's not even on his face. And it still hurts my feelings every time I see it.
So if the queen did that, are your feelings hurt? Are you bothered by that? Do you feel disrespected?
Yeah, because it's, you don't take into any consideration. You just blow right over it. It doesn't matter what I think.
I asked you not to do it, and you did it anyway.
Yeah.
And I told you that it was going to make me sad, but you don't care.
You don't care, and now I'm telling you, you're getting to a level where I'm not going to find you attractive on that. And I can only help how I feel. I can't lie about it. I know some people are like, well, that's not right. You should love her no matter what. Well, I'm going to love her. But attraction is something that I don't know. A lot of times you have control over that.
Attraction,
as a person.
It's his truth.
No, you can't control who you're attracted to.
I think you find certain things attractive. Now, you can still love the person and be like, hey, sure, I'm attracted to their qualities, but physically, I still want the attraction. Line.
There are turn-ons and turn-offs.
Right, and there's an artist that I think is very pretty, a young country artist, and she has face tattoos. And I was like, huh, it kind of kills the attraction for me on her, and I just know that we'd be going down that route with my wife.
Well, that's a celebrity artist. That's a musician.
You're right,
talking
exactly
about your wife.
Yeah,
the preschool teacher.
Those are two different worlds.
But absolutely.
I'm curious because I wouldn't be able to take that if I expressed myself and someone still did it. Kind of like the neck tattoo. You weren't happy about that,
right?
And then it's going down the same road. What do you do in that situation emotionally? Because you are upset about
it. Drink.
No, I think what happens, and this is what I'm worried about, you start to withdraw. And if it gets to a certain level, and it's like, okay, yeah, all right, I'm not, it's like, I'm not feeling it. You know, and that's where we're going to get. And that's not good for a marriage.
No.
You know, when you're kind of that way, and you're like, all right, I'm not feeling this.
People always ask me, so like a moment like this, are you going to get beef from the queen for talking about this?
No, because she knows that this is what we do. And look, you're bringing it on to yourself. And this is, hey, this is how I make my money. And this is, you know, relating real life. And it's also, too, to get a little bit of perspective. Because the way I'm leaning on it right now is I think I'm going to just have this kind of honest conversation with her. And I choke back the words over the weekend and say, give it a little bit of time. Let's see where it goes.
Don't say nothing yet.
And my daughter knows how I feel about it. And that's why I was like, so what happened? Like, you weren't going to talk to her, and clearly some conversation happened, and now she's going to go a higher level than you. Like, she's not going to go a little subtle on the front part of the neck. She's going to go on
face.
The face. Yeah.
By the ear.
Right.
But, yeah.
It's
by the area where a man's sideburn is.
And the reason why I'm scared is nothing has stopped this train. It's just, I thought, okay, I'm not going to say anything about the first two or three or four.
Every idea came to fruition.
The train is not, it's picking up momentum.
Well, you don't get listened to. You express opinions and how you feel. And
right.
I mean, it's just, that's what it sounds like.
I would listen. If my wife said something about, hey, I find that attractive on you, I would listen because I care about being attracted to my wife. So I would just tell her, be like, I'm telling you that if you start going face tattoos, I'm not going to really be attracted to you. It's going to affect our marriage. I don't know where it ends, but I'll just tell you that's where it goes. So if you want to just be, hey, well, buddy, buddy, and I'll knuckle bump you because I don't really find you that attractive, that's where the marriage is going.
Do you think sometimes
we're going to a knuckle bump marriage?
Is that what she wants?
I don't know. Maybe it is.
Do you think sometimes it is done to if you express you don't like it, do you find that then that makes her want to do it even more?
Well, then you got to ask her and be like, hey, what do you think about the marriage? Are you trying to sabotage it? Do you not want me touching you? If that's the case, then why are we married? We can still be friends and keep it amicable. And, you know, we just won't find any attraction to each other. And it's a different kind of relationship. Then we're great friends.
That's depressing.
Well, it's the truth, right?
I mean, yeah.
How else does it go?
If anybody else can
walk me through it and tell me, hey, you're taking this way out of line.
No, you're not taking it way out of line because
I don't think you're the only person to go through this, because I went through it with Panda with his neck tat that I still to this day hate.
Yeah.
And when I see it, you know, he's got the hair growing over it now, so I can't see it as much.
Right.
But when he gets a haircut, I see it and it makes me sad because I said, please don't do that. I don't want that, and it didn't matter.
I've worked with you for 20 years, and I can tell when you're annoyed, or I can tell there's some emotion behind this, which is I'm glad you show it.
It's finally gotten to the point where there's just now there's the line that I kind of drew, and with this, the line I feel is crossed to me.
They're dancing on your line.
And do you feel like it's going to definitely happen, in your opinion?
I think we're at a better chance than not that it's going to happen, and probably soon. And so, you know, I gave it the weekend, and the next chance as the conversation comes up, I'm going to say, look, please, I'm just asking for this. Can you just give me like no face tats? Man, I'm not down with face tats.
I'm not going to lie. Marriage sounds like a lot of fun.
It shouldn't be this difficult. It really shouldn't. I mean, I think that's a reasonable request, right?
Yeah, I don't think.
Can we not go face tats?
It is not a crazy request. I think face, neck, I think all of that area is just, it's next level. It's not the same as a sleeve. Mm-hmm. It's not the same as a, you know, torso tat.
Wrote all that.
Face and neck is just different.
And I've even adapted to the neck tat, but it's just the face, nah. I'm not going to adapt to that.
You are not wrong, and you shouldn't feel bad about this.
Yeah.
You shouldn't feel bad. I know someone's going to say, it's her body, and blah, blah.
I agree.
We all understand that. We all get that.
And
that's not what we're talking about.
That's why, look, if she wants to do it, she can do it, but you do what you want to do. I'll let you know how it'll make me feel, and we'll see if that makes any impression on you. And then we'll see where it goes from there. So this is step one, and now we got to just kind of see where it rides. I'll wait for the opportunity to present itself, and it will. And I will take it to the next level and have basically the conversation I just had with you guys.
Good luck.
And then we'll see where it goes, and I'll bring it back in. I'll let you know if it had any effect.
I hope it works out, man.
I do too.
I hope the face tat at least looks good.
Well, the thing that always amuses me about this is somebody gets something in a different language, and then they find out from somebody who's Hebrew that, oh, that says something really profane, you know? Like, that's not the word canon at all. Like, I know what you're talking about, and you're going to be very offensive to anybody who can read Hebrew.
How does canon feel about mom getting his name tattooed on her face?
I don't think he even knows or cares. He's whatever.
Because I'd be weirded out.
Yeah, maybe I need to just play video games all the time. That's how he seems to just close yourself in a room and play some video games.
That's what you should do.
Maybe this is what
maybe
I need
you
to
get
do
the
too.
Teen boy tune out.
Yeah,
you should get that little shed you have outside with all the rats and turn that into your own game room.
This maybe is why a lot of times you'll see dads in the family just sitting and staring out the window for like 20 minutes.
Oh, right. I saw it. My dad, I would ask him a question. Hey, Dad, well, when are we playing tennis? And then 23 minutes later, about 9 a.m., he just was staring off
just
in
thinking
the distance.
About it all.
Just thinking about, man, it's tough in these parts.
You ladies give us guys a lot to think about, man. A lot to think about.
I don't want
to
spin cycle. Yeah.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Wow. I mean, so much craziness around Cat Williams, but boy, I didn't see this one. At a Cat Williams show over the weekend, a giant bloody brawl breaks out in the audience. What the heck happened? I'll tell you coming up in your dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
It's Subaru Loves the Earth Month. This continued commitment to protecting the planet is just one of the reasons why Subaru is more than a car company. Visit SchumacherSubaru.com to learn about how they are taking action in our community to help save the sea turtles. Still dealing with major delays this morning on the Turnpike southbound. Earlier, all lanes were shut down before Indian Town Road. Now one lane is getting by, but if you can, make sure to avoid the Turnpike to save yourself some time this morning. You're also slow on 95 southbound through the same area. An accident before Indian Town Road is off to the left shoulder, but still causing about a 2-mile slowdown in the area. Traffic, a service of Massage Envy. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Having one of those weeks? Take a break and book some me time at Massage Envy. Book your next massage, facial, or stretch at MassageEnvy.com. Massage Envy, where better begins. Massage Envy is always hiring licensed massage therapists and estheticians.
When we made our McDonald's Spicy Chicken McNuggets, you were praise hands emoji. Then we ran out, and you were streaming tears emoji. Now they're back, so you can be grinning face with sweat emoji. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Spicy Chicken McNuggets are back for a hot minute at McDonald's. Now get 25% off any purchase of $1 or more when you order ahead in the McDonald's app. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Offer valid through April 21st, 2024 at participating McDonald's. Valid once a day. Must opt into rewards. Excludes tax.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is. But the rest of your body? Oh, yes. It's gonna relish every moment of it. Because there are drinks. Then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink, like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Tell you, hormones are really important. They can make you crazy. They can change your body, and that's why it's so important to have them balanced. I didn't know anything about them until my early 30s. I was having a hard time with my body, putting on lean muscle, and my trainer said, your hormones dictate that. Testosterone is what builds muscle in men. So I went and got tested. I had abominably low levels of testosterone. So I got them balanced to the place where they need to be. And I didn't realize that for guys starting in your mid-20s, around 25 every year, you lose 1 pound of lean muscle and replace it with 1 pound of fat, all because of dropping testosterone levels. But it's not just about guys. Ladies, you have more hormones than guys do. So keeping them balanced does so many other things for you. Your energy is better. Your metabolism is better, so you don't start packing on that weight. Your libido is better, and you can fight off hot flashes and night sweats. So go on ahead and get your free consultation today online at WellingtonAntiAging.com. That's WellingtonAntiAging.com.
If you're unaware, T-Mobile calls themselves the Uncarrier, which is fitting considering they just unraveled their price lock guarantee for new customers. If you ask me, that's pretty uncool. If you're uncomfortable with a company that says one thing but does another, then switch to Xfinity, whose whole home Wi-Fi, wired internet, service, speed, and reliability are unparalleled. Unjoin the Uncarrier. Switch to Xfinity today. Now through April 21st, new customers can get 300 megabits per second Xfinity Internet for $35. And ask how you can save 40% over T-Mobile in your first year. Switch today. Go to Xfinity.com/TMOFAX, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account and a 1-year contract. Connect more Internet versus T-Mobile home Internet. $60 a month. Regular pricing applies after promo period. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Effective for new customers after 1/17/2024. T-Mobile's price lock will only reimburse your last bill if you terminate service due to a price increase.
At Begin Anew, they do so many fun anti-aging things. I am so about it. If you're feeling like you're sluggish, maybe you get a little brain fog, your energy is slowing down, it could be hormones. And at Begin Anew, they check everything. They do that total optimal wellness check where they look at your hormones. They look at your food sensitivities. They look at your vitamins, your nutrients. I mean, everything. Organ function. They break it all down and let you know exactly what's going on. going on the inside that affects how you feel on the outside. And if you're looking to lose weight, they've got the semaglutide. If you're looking to do laser hair removal, they've got amazing new lasers. I love new lasers. The age of the laser really does matter. Ask. And I love at Begin Anew, too, that they can bundle together all the things that you love in a VIP package, and you get savings and free monthly treatments. Go to beginanewmed.com and see them in Jupiter right there on Indian Town Road. Beginanewmed.com.
Easy Cater. 100,000 restaurants, one platform. Need food for a meeting or a company event? Easy Cater has everything you need to make food for work, work. With easy online ordering and reordering. Save your favorite orders, make edits as needed, and click. We even help you with expenses by keeping your receipts all in one place, which means all you need to do is sit back and enjoy the food. From ordering to reporting, Easy Cater has everything to make food for work, work. Order 24/7 at easycater.com.
We did something so cool last year, and I'm telling everybody, everybody should do this because it's free and it could save your life. We're talking about going to Life Imaging FLA, just like Kevin and I did last year, getting that free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements at Life Imaging FLA. It's a $699 value.
Here's why I love doing it. I don't like to be prodded or poked. I went in there, in 10 minutes, I just laid there. There were no dyes, no need to undress. It is a free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements, a $699 value, and it's not just about the heart. They do cancer screening and virtual colonography as well.
80% of the people who go get a report back just like Kevin and I did. Zero blockages, no drama, nothing that's going to take us out. And that gave me peace of mind. I don't know about you, Kevin, but I loved getting that zero blockage score.
I want to know. I just don't want to be poked. That's right. It. And Life Imaging FLA is offering this free heart scan right now with a few minimum requirements. From your cell, call #250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's #250, keyword free heart scan.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, I don't know if you saw the video of the Cat Williams show in Indianapolis on Saturday night. I mean, with all the hype and all the people talking about Cat Williams, it's been amazing for his live shows. He was at the Indiana Farmers Coliseum, a big venue, multi-tiered venue, It was packed with people. And everybody seemed to be having a great time at the stand-up show until they weren't. Now, it looks like up in the rafters, a big fracas broke out, and you had people punching people.
What?
A whole brawl in the stands that was so bad, it brought the show to a halt. Now, reps for Cat Williams say that it was towards the end of the show. You only missed about 5 minutes of Cat's set, but it was so bad that they had to stop the show, turn the lights on in the venue, and bring in the cops. Several people were seen leaving the venue, bloody faced, hot mess. I was watching the video, so thankful that nobody got thrown over because the fight was right there on the edge of the balcony. And I was like, oh my gosh, one wrong move and somebody's going over that very high balcony.
Yep.
That could have been very bad.
Yeah, I think it's all good publicity for him. It just shows you that he's talking about stuff. He's in the news, and you don't know what's going to happen with him.
You really don't. I mean, he's got a lot of shine on him right now, and the stuff that he's saying, I don't know.
Some of it's coming true.
Yeah. I don't know, y'all. Maybe Cat Williams ain't so crazy after all.
Well, I can't tell what's real and what are just YouTubers putting stuff up on social media, because I was watching something where they're going, oh, Jay-Z and Beyonce. Beyonce's going down next, but Beyonce's rolling over on Jay-Z.
Oh, boy.
But there's multiple videos of this. And is that real or is that just straight up gossip?
Great questions. Is that real? Would Beyonce roll over on Jay-Z?
But there's a lot of content being made about all of that.
There is, yeah. So you have to kind of wade through it and say, okay, what is real, what is not.
Because Beyonce hasn't asked for a divorce from Jay-Z.
No, but if you saw the video from the elevator with her and her sister and Jay-Z, you're like, okay, something went down. Did you see that video?
Is that an old video?
Yeah, it's a few years old.
Okay, I can't really remember. I'm going to watch it again, but I'm just seeing all
Look
this.
Look for Solange beats the crap out of Jay-Z in an elevator. It's a pretty awesome video.
It's just kind of like I was saying last week, a few months before the big whatever happens to the celebrity, you just start seeing all of these videos coming out right before it kind of happens, and I'm just seeing a lot of it with Jay-Z right now.
Yeah.
Where there's smoke.
Who knows?
Mark Summers said he got ambushed and almost tricked. He said the producers of that Quiet on the Set docuseries told him it was going to be something else when he sat down to talk about, you know, Nickelodeon. Mm-hmm. And he's like, look, I never saw anything about the toxicity with these producers. I didn't see anything inappropriate. Maybe that happened. It didn't happen to me. And yeah, I mean, he was a full grown man. He wasn't really the target that I think the pedophiles were going after. But he said that the directors of Quiet on the Set definitely ambushed him and misrepresented what they were going to be making the whole movie about. He said he has no evidence of inappropriate stuff that he saw.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what happens on that. Now that they've gotten so much shine over doing the Nickelodeon stuff, they say they're going to go on to everything in children's entertainment and looking into that. And so that'll be kind of interesting. And, you know, there's a lot of things. Some of it is, to me, a little bit of conjecture where you're saying, okay, I don't know, is that really a big sign of something there? Like this clip had come out with Diddy. He actually appeared on Nickelodeon. And what they're saying is, okay, well, this is kind of odd. Here's Diddy on Nickelodeon, now knowing what we know. And they do a gag, and it ends with putting something down a boy's pants, the front of his pants.
Oh.
And they're just
That's not aging well.
Well, in and of itself, is it a huge deal? Maybe in the moment you see it and you glaze over it, but now that you're hearing what you're hearing about Diddy and pedophilia, sex trafficking, and Nickelodeon, and then you start adding them all together.
But yeah.
You're like, why did they do that gag? Why was that the gag? Here's a bit of the audio.
So,
we can't wake up Shane.
Try symbols?
Yep.
What about sour milk?
Didn't work.
Tell you what. Take this toy helicopter. Put it down his pants.
All right, we'll do it.
And they put a toy helicopter down the front of his pants, and then they turn it on. The kid's like, oh, you know. But they're like, okay, why is that the gag that, okay, something going down the kid's pants?
But to your point, though, there are some things that people are grabbing, and you go, and you don't even know, and they're going to try to make it a thing.
And I hear that, I'm like, I don't know, but. You know, with everything starting to add up, you're just like, okay.
No, I'm sure all these documentaries, they're doing it for the children and not at all for the money.
No, they're doing it for the money. They're getting massive hits.
Massive hits.
Yeah, and you don't know that they're completely squeaky clean either. It's the business of show business, which is shady, making this docuseries about their shadiness.
Well, even the way they name them now, they have a certain name, they're naming the documentary. Yeah. It's got all of the money-making signs.
Totally. Yeah.
And I don't know if you saw the accusation against Diddy's kid, Christian.
Yeah, I was reading a little bit about that and trying to digest it.
Yes, what I think could be interesting about this. This is a girl who worked on a yacht where there was a Diddy party.
Okay, we've heard about these infamous Diddy yacht parties.
Christian Combs was 26 at the time. This girl was 25. And apparently Christian comes onto the boat to work with that producer that has filed the lawsuit against Diddy, Rodney Lil Rod Jones.
Yes.
This happened on December 28th of 2022. She said when she was on there between the hours of 6 p.m. and 6 a.m., which was her shift, that she saw a constant rotation of suspected sex workers, celebrities partying and taking drugs. And then when Christian comes on board, he's heavily intoxicated, pressures her into taking a shot of tequila, and then gets aggressive about her trying to drink more. And then she starts looking around and seeing girls falling out after having their first drink. She's like, oh my goodness, did he spike my drink?
Oh no.
Apparently he's groping her body and her private parts. She is declining alcohol and saying to stop touching her. And what could be interesting with this is apparently Lil Rod was capturing audio. Maybe he knew he was going to be turning himself in, was gathering evidence. So apparently in the audio that has been presented to some national media sources, I believe NBC maybe got their hands on it, is you can hear what sounds like Christian kind of moving in on her. You hear her saying stop, 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 and then you hear a bunch of kissing noises in the background apparently of this audio. So hey, is that enough? I don't know, but you'll probably need some eyewitnesses, and everybody's blasted out of their mind. I don't know where it's going to go. And the reason why she's kind of suing, she went to the yacht captain the following day, told him the story. He didn't believe her. And then all of a sudden, she starts getting jobs she doesn't want to do, and then she's shortly fired thereafter.
Whoa.
And now she's got the claim of emotional distress and all that stuff.
I think the other person that you're going to find that's kind of a big part of the story is Cuba Gooding Jr. I think he was...
He's tied into all this.
I think he's friends with, he was close with Diddy, and I think he was a good dude.
Yeah. Lot of
that
stuff.
Is crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if you're at a party and you see girls having their first drink and they're falling out, you got to be horrified.
Yeah,
kind of what happened at your party when I.
Well,
you gave me that wishy.
Virginia throwing Diddy parties?
Oh, her naughty party.
I gave you a 32 ounce rum punch.
It's just
a lot of rum.
A lot of rum.
A lot of punch.
I fell out after my first drink, too.
Probably a lot of rum, little punch.
I was not spiked. And that's what's going on in your dirt.
It's time for viral audio.
Hey, yeah, beautiful hair.
They can't hear me because they're listening to Kids Box.
We got weights and fit.
There we go.
Well, last night, the Country Television Music Awards were going on, the CMT Awards, Jelly Roll. He had another big night. This dude, all he does is win. Must be the face tats. He... took home all three of the awards for which he was nominated, including Video of the Year for Need a Favor. He also won Male Video of the Year and CMT Performance of the Year, and he always gives that inspirational speech, this one about second chances.
It's important that I stand up here tonight and represent those that are looking for second chances. The kids back in the Metro Davidson County Juvenile Detention Facility, the kids down here in the Austin Juvenile Detention Facility are watching this tonight. I'm cheering y'all boys on. You can be this guy. You can change. You can turn it around. I promise you can, baby. I once heard a man say that you don't change until the pain to remain the same is greater than the pain it takes to change, and that's what it takes. I love you, Texas.
He could be a Southern Baptist minister if the
yes,
country
could.
Thing doesn't work out.
Preach, Mr. Roll.
Did he heal somebody right after?
I mean, my goodness, huh? The inspiration on that.
He can cast out the demon with his hand.
Oh, yeah. Also, sad to say, we had a death in the music world. The lead singer of the band Firehouse, CJ Snare. They were a band that cranked out a couple big hits in the early 90s. He passed away from complications from colon cancer, but you might remember some of these songs.
Did I talk about Firehouse fan?
She's stung, huh?
I love that Love of a Lifetime song.
Oh,
I love
yeah.
that since I was a kid, but that first song's a banger. I've
yeah.
never heard that before.
Yeah. That was a big
it's the
hit.
Softer side.
It is.
Yes.
Of rock.
Yes.
Yeah. Big hits from back in the day, no doubt about it. And I wanted to give you a heads up. We're keeping an eye on one of our KVJ Nationers who is crushing it right now on The Voice. Serenity Arce.
She got a hold on me.
Can't sing.
She got me wrapped around her finger. Oh, oh.
been keeping me updated on what's going on. She said, you'll want to watch the knockout tonight.
Okay.
Yes. So keep an eye out for Serenity. See what she does in the knockout. I have a feeling she's going to do very well.
Oh, I'm sure Tammy is just beaming with pride.
Gosh. Yeah, they're just having a great time with this.
That's
very
awesome.
Happy for them. All right, coming up here in a couple minutes, who do you need to call out? You can let us know. We're going to start those right now, 877-979-WRMF. And we'll play a fun little round, a little kid or drunk adult. Coming up after Teddy Swims, who was playing on the beaches of Fort Lauderdale on Friday, this is Lose Control.
Something's got a hold on me lately, though I don't know myself anymore. Feels like the walls are all closing in, and the devil's knocking at my door. Whoa, out of my mind, how many times did I tell you I'm no good at being alone? Yeah, it's taking a toll on me, trying my best to keep from tearing the skin off my bones. Don't you know? Feel like a bad habit. Bad habits hard to break when I'm with you. Yeah, I know I can do it on my own, but I want that real full moon, black magic, and it takes two. Problematic. Problem is when I'm with you, I'm an addict, and I need some relief. My skin and your teeth, can't see the forest through the trees. Got me down on my knees, darling.
Little kid or drunk adult? We all do dumb things. Sometimes when we do, we're little kids. Other times, we are drunk adults. Can you tell the difference? Well, we love your submissions. Just download the very free WRMF app. Look for the little microphone in the bottom left-hand corner and then send us some audio. Tell us the dumb thing you did. Leave a little bit of a space and then let us know if you're a little kid or a drunk adult. The first submission we have here is from Jeannie. Jeannie, I'd love to hear, what is the dumb thing that you did?
I attempted to cook a frozen pizza in my toaster and ended up catching my entire kitchen on fire.
Oh, man.
I don't think little kids would be trying to cook up a pizza, right?
It's a big project for a little kid.
I always cooked pizzas. I loved it. It was a big thing for me. But I think I'm always an abnormal kid. So
Oh, yeah, no doubt. And an abnormal adult, too. I mean,
I'm making a mistake. I know that.
He's also making no changes.
Yeah.
Zero.
And the other thing, too, is I just see drunks loving pizza.
Yes. Yeah. And drunks come home from the bar and, you know, maybe you're on a budget and you can't hit Taco Bell. Mm-hmm. You know you got a frozen pizza. That's exciting.
Yeah. Okay, so Jeannie, what were you? Because I'm thinking it's a drunk adult here. What do you think?
I'm going to go little kid.
Okay, Virginia?
I'm going to go drunk adult.
Okay, what were you, Jeannie?
And the truth is I was a very, very drunk adult. Yeah. Who had way too much to drink. Uh-huh. And I thought that it would be a good idea if I cooked my French bread frozen pizza in the toaster. And I ended up passing out, and the toaster caught fire, which caused a huge fire in my kitchen. and resulted in me paying over $5,000 in damages.
Oh.
So, yeah. Drunk adult.
Okay.
Fresh bread pizza? That's a thick pizza.
How does that even fit in the toaster? You have to jam that in.
That might have been the problem.
Ugh. She jammed it in and fell asleep.
Yeah. Okay, Engineer Keith has submitted this one for us for a little kid or drunk adult. What is the dumb thing you did, Engineer Keith?
I decided it would be a good idea to try to surf a guitar down the stairs.
Surfing a guitar down the stairs.
I could see it. This is a tough one because a little kid could do that. I think it's fun, but so could a drunk person.
Wouldn't a drunk adult smash an acoustic guitar at least? I could think maybe an electric guitar, which is a little bit harder, you could try.
Virginia probably wouldn't. Virginia, she's skinny.
Are you saying how skinny I am right now?
I'm going to say you're skinny.
Oh, Jaybird, you like this, don't you?
But we are talking to man here.
Drink it in, big boy.
Well, who knows? Maybe he did break it.
That's true.
Yeah, he didn't say he
didn't. That's true. Yeah. What do you think Engineer Keith was here, Virginia?
I'm going little kid.
Bird?
Drunk adult.
I'm going to go with Virginia, little kid. What were you, Engineer Keith?
I was a little kid, and Dad was not happy.
I guess it was Dad's guitar.
I guess it sounds fun.
And Amanda, she did something dumb once upon a time. What was it, Amanda?
I started dancing on the table at a restaurant and fell on an old woman's head.
A little kid's not going to get away with dancing on a table for long. I wouldn't think.
Would an adult? I guess depending on what kind of table it is.
If you got a bunch of drunks around you.
Some places encourage it.
I think a drunk adult goes longer than a little kid at dancing.
I think this was a move of like 20 years ago. A lot of places let you dance on the table.
I'm looking at somebody.
Remember
right
those
now.
Greek places? They loved it. Yes. They encouraged it. Yeah.
We would go and they would be mad at us if we didn't get up on the table and throw the napkins.
Right, yeah.
And I'm more than happy to get up on a table. Yeah. I love to shake it.
You twerked at a table in Miami while we were having dinner with our boss.
Yeah.
We didn't stay around much longer after that.
Upside down twerk.
She did.
Impressive, yeah.
At the booth.
Yeah. I loved it. I think everyone else at the table was weirded out, which made it even funnier. But I don't think they got the joke.
All you need is one guy to smile.
That's
you
it.
Sometimes you do an act for one.
But all the guys were on the KVJ show. All right. Jaybird, what do you think Amanda was? She fell on a stranger dancing on a table.
She got a drunk adult. Drunk adult.
Drunk adult.
I feel drunk adult as well. What were you, Amanda?
Yeah, I was a drunk adult.
Yeah.
I ended up falling off a table at Duffy's, and I landed on top of an old woman I never met.
Duffy's?
She called me a hooker and said I stank of beer. It was a mess. I was going through a breakup. What do you want? I don't know.
Yeah, okay.
When you're going through a breakup, you're allowed to do crazy stuff like that.
Oh, you are? Yes. Okay, you get a pass.
You do get a pass. All right. It's a little aggressive at Duffy's.
It's so over the top at Duffy's.
That is very over the top. At Duffy's.
Duffy's?
All right, if you've got a submission, get that WRMF app and use the mic drop feature for little kid or drunk adult. All right, your column outs are coming up here in a couple of minutes. And this does feel kind of weird, but I'm calling out a pastor today.
Good.
A pastor needs to be called out.
Sometimes you got to call him out.
And I'm putting him on blast next.
97.9 WRMF wants to get you into Taylor Swift's The Eras Tour in Miami. You've got to decode the friendship bracelets to get your entry. That's right, Swifties. We know you love an Easter egg, and this is your chance to prove you're a Taylor Swift mastermind. Your mission is to listen each weekday at 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m. for the clues to decode the friendship bracelet of the day to get your entry. But you'll need to be quick and follow along to win. Decode, leading up to the release of her new album on April 19th. Get rules and contest info at WRMF.com. And psst, maybe a few hints are inside our mobile app.
from the WRMF Anna Jar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anna Jar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
It's Subaru Loves the Earth Month. This continued commitment to protecting the planet is just one of the reasons why Subaru is more than a car company. Visit SchumacherSubaru.com to learn about how they are taking action in our community to help save the sea turtles. Still seeing heavy delays this morning following an earlier accident involving a tractor trailer on the turnpike southbound. This is on the approach to Indiantown Road. Give yourself plenty of extra time through that area. 95 southbound also moving slowly through that area following an accident that has been cleared off to the shoulder before Indiantown Road. Expect 2 mile delay through there. And we have a crash that is blocking a center lane currently on 95 northbound, this one at Palmetto Park Road, causing fairly heavy delays. Traffic a service of Massage Envy. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Having one of those weeks? Take a break and book some me time at Massage Envy. Book your next massage, facial, or stretch at MassageEnvy.com. Massage Envy, where better begins. Massage Envy is always hiring licensed massage therapists and estheticians.
Demand Dave! 844-411-1LAW. Demand Dave! For a car accident or slip and fall. Need a personal injury lawyer? Come rest and come rest. Make the call. 844-411-1LAW.
I love the fact that I don't have to wear glasses or mess around with contact lenses. And it's all because I got a LASIK procedure a decade ago at Panu Laser. And I tell everybody to do it. The reasons why. It's a lot easier than you would ever think. Lasers do all the work. You lay there for 90 seconds per eye. That's it. And your vision clears up, and then you're back to work or whatever you want to do the very next day. There's no downtime. And you're not going to be upset by the price tag either. I know everything seems so expensive, but this is one of those things that was crazy affordable. And even if you don't have the money today, they got a payment plan we don't need until way down the line. Like big time tomorrow, talking next year. 2025, baby. It's zero down, zero interest for up to 12 months. And they got convenient locations all over South Florida. Plus, you've got Dr. Mutiella, who's performed over 100,000 LASIK procedures, so you're in the best hands possible. So why wouldn't you do this? If you don't want the glasses or contacts, make the move. Book the appointment right now at PanuLaser.com. Drop my name, Kim, from the KVJ Show, for an additional $500 off when you go to PANNULaser.com.
Business. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these companies is a partner helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup and the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all choose the Advanced Network, Cybersecurity Solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business, the company that powers more businesses than anyone else. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
See why Comcast Business powers more small businesses than anyone else. Get started with fast speeds and advanced security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get up to an $800 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call to switch today. Ends 5/6/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Eco bill and auto pay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
Have you struggled to lose weight in the past? Hey, it's Suits from the KVJ Show, and it has never been really easy for me. I've tried a couple of weight loss programs, and you know how it goes. Either you lose the weight and then immediately put it back on, or you just can't even lose the weight to begin with. Well, after doing a couple of those, I tried out the Coastal Weight Loss Secret Program with Dr. Zuckerman, and it changed everything. I dropped 30 pounds in just 2 months, and that's what most people do. They drop 20 to 30 pounds in about a month or two, and the best part about it is it was so easy. Their unique weight loss program will help you lose that weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely and effectively. And you can do it without counting points or calories. There's no exercising required. You don't have to worry about any surgeries, and there's no prepackaged meals either. Everything you need, you can make at home with stuff you bought from the grocery store. Then once you lose that weight, they stick with you for the maintenance phase. This is the big difference with Coastal Weight Loss Secret. It doesn't end when you reach your goal. They stay with you to make sure you don't put that weight back on. Find out the secret to losing up to a pound of fat every day with Dr. Zuckerman and Coastal Weight Loss Secret. You can give them a call and schedule a free consultation at 561-680-39 or online at CoastalWeightLossSecret.com.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
Hey, it's Jay Bird. Oh, are you hungry? Let's talk Dunkin'. How about that bacon, egg, and cheese breakfast sandwich? I know you can smell it. You can hear me talking. Get that thing in your belly. And I suggest extra cheese. Maybe stuff some tater tots in that. Hash browns. I got all kind of carbs on the brain right now. Stuff some hash browns in the bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich. It is delicious. Takes it to that next level. The wake up wrap too on their breakfast sandwich menu. So make sure you try one of those. DB Perks membership's gonna get you deals galore. I'm Jay Bird and I run on Dunkin'.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H-Grade West Palm Beach Weather Center.
The spring sale event has already started at hgrade.com. Used cars from $64.97. This is the best time of the year to upgrade your car. Drive your new car today. Don't wait. Visit hgrade.com now. H-G-R-E-G.com.
Great viewing for the partial eclipse this afternoon. We'll see partly sunny skies. Daytime highs in the upper 70s with an easterly wind. Tonight, overnight lows dropping down to about 70 degrees. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Steve Villanueva on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by StormTight Windows.
Brace yourselves. StormTight has a deal that will blow you away. We're raining down savings with 50% off installation of all new windows. That's extreme savings on extreme weather protection. Visit us online and lock down these savings today. Go to StormTightWindows.com.
Workers' Compensation Claim, Gordon & Partners, 561-333-3333.
What you need to know on the KVJ Show.
I'm already seeing some of the comments in the KVJ-TV chat room on YouTube. And they're saying, well, I guess I'm listening to WRMF every minute of every day today. Let me just tell you that you do want to be here definitely at 9, 11, 1, 3, and 5 p.m. Because if you want these Taylor Swift tickets, which they did a big special on the news today about how your tickets are looking at about $2,000 a piece.
Dang.
If you want to go.
Even if you have no interest in Taylor.
Right.
Yeah. Resale, baby.
$2,000. And then they're talking about all the scams that are out there on top of it. They're taking people. And I got to tell you, this ain't scammy. We got a legit pair for the Hard Rock Stadium show and the Eras Tour Saturday, October 19th. We're going to be giving out little clues that you need to decode Taylor Swift's friendship bracelet to you. At 9 a.m., you're going to get your first clue, and then the others come at 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m., and they're different clues. So that's why you want to be here, because you don't want to miss any of them. If you can be the first to decode that, you want to be jumping on there, and you're going to need the WRMF app to do it. So go on ahead and download that and get ready. I'll give you all the details coming up here at 9 a.m. on the KVJ Show.
If somebody's done you wrong, it's time for you to sing along. Call them out, call them out, call them out. You gotta call them out, call them out, call them out. It's time to call them out.
Well, who do you need to call out today and for what? My first call them out that I think is deserved. It's kind of weird because I'm calling out a pastor here, but dude, come on, man. What are you doing? Matt Baker, the lead pastor at Trinity Christian Academy on Military Trail near Lake Worth, he described recognizing Autism Awareness Week as, quote, demonic. In an email he sent out to parents, he wrote, if Jesus Christ led Trinity, would he have an Autism Awareness Week? Of course not. Why? Because anything that exalts itself above the name of Christ should be brought down. Also, anything that teaches our children to have their identity in anything other than Christ is idolatry and demonic. I got to tell you, dude, spent my whole life in the church. I strongly disagree with this. I don't think it's putting anything above God. I think it is trying to make kids feel normalized and that they are not some kind of outlier in society and they need a little bit of support. And that's all it is. And to me, I don't think there's anything more Christian than giving somebody support and wanting to make them feel like they are special in the way that God has treated them. So I just think it's a terrible message, and I think you're way off base on this, dude. I really think you need to pull it back. And not to mention, too, man, this is very hurtful. One mom in the story I read was left in tears, and now she's pulling her kids out of the school, and I think that's the right move. She said, I'm offended as a Christian because I feel like he is using the Bible for his own interpretation, and his interpretation is offensive, not just to my son, but any child, adult, afflicted with autism. It breaks my heart. And a teacher's aide was fired this week after she said she posted the pastor's email on social media because she wanted people to know about it.
People need to know about it. When somebody does something stupid, you post their email, that is a good thing.
Yeah.
People need to know that this man has it twisted. And if this is the way that he wants to run the school, he shouldn't be in power.
Right.
If he can't be compassionate and understanding and loving to kids that are different, get him out of there.
I mean, you nailed it with what you said. I mean, that's the complete opposite of what...
Yeah. What would Jesus do? Wouldn't do that.
Of a loving way.
Yeah. Exactly. You need to lead with compassion. No one's trying to exalt themselves over Christ by observing Autism Awareness Week. My goodness, man. So, yeah, you're right. Honestly, especially in the church, man, you've got to be really in tune to be a leader. And it's tough because, unfortunately, we've had too many stories of people that should not be leaders in the church that are giving it all a bad name. And I would definitely take it to prayer and reconsider their Matt Baker. Just my thought. That's my call him out today.
Get him, Kev.
Yeah. I'm on it. I'm on it.
Jesus, Kev has spoken.
That's it. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm done. Kind of a call him out here. Jennifer is putting out the feelers. She said, I just got home now from tonight's Madonna concert. And the timestamp on this morning at 5:36 a.m.
Whoa.
It says that she started around, 22:15 instead of 20:30. So I guess that they're going on military time. So you're saying, 10 o'clock instead of 8 o'clock instead of 8:30. So she was almost 2 hours late. I'd love to hear if any other KVJ Nationers went and what they thought of the show. This is Madonna's thing, but she is currently going through a pending lawsuit in about a show that happened at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn about doing that and starting all crazy late. And I don't get it. Honestly, I don't know.
Sunday night.
Well, some people are saying, hey, that's Madonna. It's what you expect. What is the difference between the Madonna show? And if you go see anything in Miami, a lot of those shows, you go to clubs. And I mean, some of those people, they take the stage. I think Bruno Mars, when he played at Dare after a show, I think he was on stage at 3 a.m., something like that. So.
But I think it's not cool to do. I think it's, unless there's a travel reason or something happens, but if you're able to do it and you're not doing it just because of your ego.
I don't get the flex. It's a weird, it is a weird flex. Maybe that's just it. Madonna thinks, remember she's dabbled in the dance music and that's maybe a clubby dance thing. And she's like, this is just when we live, man. I'm doing this for my audience.
But. Yeah, and I think I've seen a clip of her ranting about people that complain about her being late. And it was so unlikable. You're kind of like, you don't get why people are mad that you're 2 hours late.
If you want to go on stage at 10, great. But just put that on the ticket.
And I think that might be it because what they're saying is here's the timestamp from when she came on an hour and 45 minutes after what the ticket said. So you're right. Don't be giving me this time. Hey, if that's it, let me know what I am getting myself involved with.
Well, how are other artists able to do it and Madonna can't? You're Madonna. You can start your show on time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So there you go. Somebody else with a call out here today. I'd like to call out the old guy who swooped in front of me to take the last pair of solar eclipse glasses.
Oh, damn.
I think I might get some today.
You're starting to Jones for it?
Well, you need them if you want to watch it.
I know.
You can't just watch it if you don't prepare ahead of time and get those glasses.
Well, you were talking about they're selling the glasses at 7-Eleven. I'm jonesing for a Slurpee. I mean, that's kind of like the universe saying, dude, watch the eclipse, enjoy Slurpee.
7-Eleven also has beer.
Oh, I already got it. I'm stacked up right now. I had the snack pack over all weekend. I'm stocked.
Somebody else said, I want to call out each and every one of these a-holes that see the yellow light and instead of slowing down, they gun it and then cross straight through running a red light. Idiots are going to kill somebody. Yeah, that's Florida driving. We had talked about this, last week, I think, on the show with the column outs. And there is an understanding. If you've driven in South Florida long enough, you understand the styles and what people are going to do. And that's just it. You can't trust yellow lights means speed up to get through. That was the joke that the guy even said, right?
Right.
The audio we played. Yellow doesn't mean slow down to stop. It means speed up to get through this light. And it's almost like they don't see red. They'd be like, well, it's kind of pink. Well, no, but that's just South Florida driving. It is terrible.
I'm convinced 25% of South Florida drivers are hopped up on some kind of goofball or pill or something. I'm telling you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Somebody said in response to Madonna, I went to a Tortuga, Jason Aldean. He was scheduled to come out at 8:20. He came out a little late at 8:23.
That's perfect.
You know what? Country artists respect their fans.
Exactly.
Yes, that would not fly in country music. They would be like, who do you think you are?
Exactly.
And that's the way you do it.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So I think that is the way to do it.
Madonna can be rough, man. I'm sorry. She can.
Not my style.
I like some of her older songs, but she can be a little rough.
Yeah, I would not be going in for it. Somebody else wants to call out their mother-in-law for coughing in their husband's face and getting him super sick for over a week now.
Oh, no.
Was it done on purpose?
Mm-hmm.
I think if you're sick, you need to go and not be around unsick people. That's not cool.
Yeah.
Coughing in somebody's face. Mm-hmm. Come on now.
Yep. And I saw a debate on my next door. It was a column out, and there were some people that were kind of pushing back. It was a bus driver who kicked an elderly man off the bus, saying that he stunk. And this was after the gentleman paid his fare and got onto the bus. The driver called him back and made a scene of kicking him off, saying like he had soiled himself. Now, I may be wrong, but aren't these the people that we should be helping? It's shameful to me that this man may have been trying to make it to a bathroom when the unpredictable happened.
Oh, that breaks my heart.
So, Mr. Bus Driver, as karma tends to keep immaculate records, I'm sure your kindness and humility shall find its way back to you when you least expect it. And that was the call out. And other people said, well, don't. Bus drivers have a responsibility. If somebody's to that level, can you let them on the bus? And less people took that position as they did. Look, if there's a dude and, yeah, he may be older and maybe he has had an accident.
You want to help him out. But one, two, three, not it.
You don't want to sit maybe right next to him. Right. It's one of those where you feel the compassion, but you're like, all right.
You can sit in the front. We're going to all sit in the back.
My compassion works stronger the further away I am from you.
I'm like, oh, the poor guy. Can someone help him, please?
Right. So that was the interesting call him out that definitely got a lot of comments. All right. You got to call him out. You need to get through to us. You can do that. 877-979-WRMF, 877-979-9763. And had to save a little bit of time because Virginia's got to call him out here for a familiar name of somebody she has had beef with in the past. Everything had been good, we thought. But something happened over the weekend, and Virginia's about to go on blast again next.
Forget. thought it was all good, that the beef had been squashed and settled. There were no more problems. And then over the weekend, something happened. And now Virginia's back on the warpath, and she has to put someone on blast.
But Kevin, I'm trying to figure out who this could be, but then I was realizing there's so many people she has beef with.
I don't.
This is a hard game.
I'm about to have beef with you if you don't cut it out.
She could never have beef with me.
Virginia, who is it that you need to put on blast and for what here today?
Well, I know you remember just a few months ago, my daughter Magnolia was having all that drama with the roommate that brought the cat in the apartment, was terrorizing her, calling her, telling her, oh, the cat peed in your room. This is the same former roommate that she ran off the last girl.
Mm-hmm.
We'll call that last girl Rose.
Okay.
She ran off the last roommate, Rose, by putting crickets in her bed.
Oh, boy.
So we'll call the mean roommate Cricket.
Okay.
Cricket's got a boyfriend.
Okay.
So it's been peaceful with Cricket. Ever since I went up there and I sat Cricket down and I was nice to Cricket and I tried to win her over and say, look, you can't be doing this. Are you okay? Mm-hmm. What's going on? Like, me and Cricket, we bonded. And it's been great with her. Magnolia and Cricket, they go out together. They get coffee for each other.
Yeah.
They do stuff on the weekends. They've been great.
Mm-hmm. Everything sounded awesome.
But Cricket's boyfriend, which he's been in the picture the whole time, and he's been kind of a wild card.
So let's call him Wild Card.
Wild Card. You got Cricket and Wild Card. Now, Cricket's been behaved, Wild Card not so much.
Okay.
So they were all out on Saturday night together, all the girls, all the roommate girls, and they were having a great time. Wild Card shows up, and Wild Card vocally doesn't like Magnolia, tells her he doesn't like her.
Okay.
Why? He's just a D. He's a giant D.
Mm-hmm.
He is 27 years old, first of all. He doesn't go to FSU. He goes to FAMU.
As a teacher?
No, he's a student. He's a senior. He's been a senior for 4 years.
He's been a senior for 4 years?
I guess. That's what they told me. I don't know. I mean, he's 27 years old.
Look, good heavens.
We do know that.
Senior year is very hard, Kevin.
I don't know.
What the heck?
Why this full-grown man, like, he keeps hanging out with these young freshmen, sophomore.
That's
because
weird.
Magnolia's got friends in her sorority, and they know him. Uh-huh. They're like, we know him.
Right.
He has been hanging around younger college girls for years. He's been the older creepy guy for years.
So Wild Card just likes to
get wild. And he doesn't like Magnolia because Magnolia tells him like it is. Magnolia doesn't like him hanging out, being Wild Card, being disrespectful, saying things out of pocket to her or any of the roommates.
Yeah.
So when he showed up on Saturday night, Magnolia said, peace, I'm out. She left.
Okay.
The other roommates stayed out with Wild Card. So you got Cricket, you got Wild Card, and then you got Magnolia's very, very good friend that she's had since she was 3 years old. We'll call her Supermodel. She's super hot, super tall.
Okay.
Hot. So it's Wild Card, Cricket, and Supermodel. And I guess something went down after Magnolia left, and Wild Card started fighting with Supermodel.
Okay.
And they fight the whole way home in the Uber. They get back to the apartment. Magnolia's like doing her skincare routine and trying to go to bed. And all she hears is a ruckus out in the common area that all these girls share.
Okay.
There's some sort of argument. There's a squabble verbally going on. And Supermodel is asking Wild Card to leave. And he's refusing to leave. He's being loud. He's fighting with everybody.
Dude won't go.
Cricket is loving it. She's laughing about the fact that he is speaking so disrespectfully to Supermodel.
Okay.
So Magnolia has to go out there and she has to insert herself in trying to remove him. And then he gets lippy and tells Mags, she's fat, she's disgusting, everybody in your sorority hates you, you're gross, you're stupid. Like, he goes in on Mags. Hmm. And now they're in a full-on verbal altercation. She's still asking him to leave. He's not leaving.
Mm-hmm.
So Magnolia gets her stuff. stuff, and she leaves.
Okay.
She goes and she spends the night in one of her friend's apartments downstairs in the same building because she's not going to sleep here with this lunatic wild card.
Yeah.
Wilding out. He's just yelling at everybody now. Mm-hmm. And Cricket's loving it. She's laughing. She thinks it's funny. So the next morning, supermodel wakes up. She leaves town.
Okay.
She was so upset by the whole thing. She's now back in Palm Beach County.
Okay.
And Magnolia's calling me like, Mom, what do I do? What do I do? And I can't have this.
No.
I can't have wild card in this apartment that I pay for. I'm on the lease. He's not.
Right.
How is wild card in the apartment? Two of the roommates are asking him to leave and he won't leave and he's fighting. He's a 27-year-old man. He's very jacked. He works out. He's beefy. He's intimidating.
He's not a dude.
I've met him. I saw him out in the clubs. Mm-hmm. Magnolia pointed him out to me. So I know what he looks like. He works out, y'all. Okay.
Do you know who I really feel bad in this story? That Uber driver.
Oh, my gosh. That poor Uber driver. They're fighting in the car.
Oh, man.
The drama. It's in the hall. I mean, it's just, it's so dramatic. This is just Cricket, though. This is Cricket for you.
Yeah.
I think if there is no drama, she creates drama.
Yeah, some people thrive on it. They love it.
She did it to the last roommate, and now she's continuing to do it. It's a pattern for her.
Yeah.
But I can't have this man in the apartment. I can't have him fighting with these girls. So what would you do if you were me?
Well, he just comes and goes, right?
Yes. They're on again, off again. And when he's there, he also fights with Cricket, too, very loudly. They have loud fights. Then they have loud makeup sex.
Okay. So, I mean, you're talking about somebody that she's hooking up with, and he's a toxic individual that comes over and brings a toxicity with him.
Yes. They smoke pot in the living room. None of the other roommates smoke pot. It's all in the air in the living room.
Yeah. I mean, it's a bad roommate situation, which I think if you've ever lived in college with anybody, you have bad roommates, and you have bad situations that happen. You know, you're talking about, what, trying to put a ban on having this guy come in? I think that's a tough thing.
I know. Because that's the thing. Like, Cricket didn't want him to go, but Magnolia and Supermodel wanted him to go, and he stayed, and Magnolia left.
The only thing is you got two against one when it comes to roommates and say, hey, look, you know, we shouldn't have to leave our own place, and they can try to stand up to her and be more forceful and say that ain't right and hopefully convince her that he's got to behave, and he can't be causing fights with everybody. If you're going to do this and you're going to smoke your weed, go into your bedroom and stay away from us. We don't want to see him because he just causes problems here. And, you know, it's a fight that I think your daughter's got to take on her own. She's got to stand up. She's got the numbers, and that's important in life. She's got the numbers. So.
All right.
I shouldn't
go up there.
You gave her the wrong advice, Kevin.
No.
Yours was very sound.
Yours is sound.
She wants to go up to Tallahassee and confront Wild Card?
I do kind of want to go up to confront Wild Card. I'm not scared of Wild Card.
I think she wants to sit down and have another heart-to-heart talk with Cricket.
I don't care if he works out. He can work out right now.
Well, I mean, it should have no effect. You're talking about a woman. So, I mean, if he ever tries anything physical with a woman, then you're talking about a different level, and then the cops need to get involved at that point.
Yeah, if he's being all verbally abusive, and record him and send it to the cops. If he's being out of pocket, it's so over the top. Show
I'm
to the
fear.
Police.
Yeah, I'm afraid of my own place.
If it's not over the top, then that just she's almost done with the lease, right?
Yeah.
Yes. I mean, we have literally months left, and it is over. And Magnolia did not renew the lease with Cricket, but Supermodel did. She's back in this situation.
That's silly that you
for the whole next year with this craziness.
Bye. Good luck.
That's what I'm thinking. Bye.
Yeah, that's it. Well,
I can't wait.
Not much time left. That'd be it. So just tell Mags, stand your ground and suck it up until the school year's over.
She spoke to Cricket and she said, please, can he never come back in this apartment again?
Mm-hmm.
And the girl said, yes, but now let's see what happens.
Yeah. Okay, just when you think it's over, Virginia. Look at what happens, huh? Okay, I don't want to make the Swifties wait like Madonna makes her fans wait, so I'm going to get right on this here. We got Taylor Swift tickets, y'all, for that Eras Tour that is coming to Hard Rock Stadium on Saturday, October 19th. You got to be here five times every single day.
You're going to want to be here. You don't want to miss this because you get a new clue as to what this friendship bracelet says that Taylor Swift has for you to get these tickets. It's going to happen at 9, 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m. Now, the clues are hints to help you decode the phrase on the friendship bracelet. And you can also get additional clues in our mobile app, which you need to download, says WRMF in your app store. Now, you got the five daily clues, try to guess the phrase, and then when you know the phrase, you enter it into the WRMF app. You're going to have 15 minutes each play time to enter your guess, and you can guess as many times as possible, and you can enter multiple times in one day to earn more entries. And if you guess the phrase at 9 a.m. and it's correct, you can enter it again at 11, 1, 3, and 5 p.m. So here you go. The clue is seven letters, two words, two letter E's. You want to write this down.
Wait, what? Say it again.
Seven letters.
Seven letters.
Two words and two letter E's. That is your first clue. Seven letters, two words, two letter E's.
That's easy.
Bird's already got it all solved.
That's easy.
Look at that. It's already all solved for the bird.
There's no possible way you have it solved.
Oh, you're calling my bluff?
Yeah.
Seven letters, two words, two letter E's. Next clue happens at 11 a.m.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
It's Subaru Loves the Earth Month. This continued commitment to protecting the planet is just one of the reasons why Subaru is more than a car company. Visit SchumacherSubaru.com to learn about how they are taking action in our community to help save the sea turtles. Still seeing heavy delays this morning on the Turnpike southbound following an earlier accident on the approach to Indian Town Road. Give yourself plenty of extra time through that area. And 95 southbound in the same area also moving very slowly following an earlier accident that was on the approach to Indian Town Road as well. Look for the left shoulder blocked there. There's also a crash causing heavy delays currently on Okeechobee Boulevard eastbound. This one is just beyond I-95 and two left lanes are blocked in that area. Plus, a crash is tying you up on 95 northbound before Hillsborough Boulevard. Two right lanes blocked there. Expect delays extending beyond Copens Road. And another crash tying you up is on State Road 84 eastbound beyond Hiatus Road. Look for a left lane blocked there. Traffic a service of Massage Envy. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Having one of those weeks? Take a break and book some me time at Massage Envy. Book your next massage, facial, or stretch at MassageEnvy.com. Massage Envy, where better begins. Massage Envy is always hiring licensed massage therapists and estheticians.
Autobuy's newest division, Autobuy Elite, offering the white glove service to purchase your BMW, Mercedes-Benz, Bentley, Rolls-Royce, any exotic and antique collectible automobile right from your home or office with Autobuy's newest digital technology, giving you the elite customer service.
That's Autobuy's newest division, Autobuy Elite, offering the white glove service to purchase your BMW, Mercedes-Benz, Bentley, Rolls-Royce, any exotic and antique collectible automobile right from your home or office with Autobuy's newest digital technology, giving you the elite customer service.
If you're unaware, T-Mobile calls themselves the Un-carrier, which is fitting considering they just unraveled their price lock guarantee for new customers. If you ask me, that's pretty uncool. If you're uncomfortable with a company that says one thing but does another, then switch to Xfinity, whose whole home Wi-Fi, wired internet, service, speed, and reliability are unparalleled. Unjoin the Un-carrier. Switch to Xfinity today. Now through April 21st, new customers can get 300 megabits per second Xfinity Internet for $35. And ask how you can save 40% over T-Mobile in your first year. Switch today. Go to Xfinity.com/TMOFAX, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto-pay with stored bank account and a one-year contract. Connect more Internet versus T-Mobile home Internet. $60 a month. Regular pricing applies after promo period. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Effective for new customers after 1/17/2024. T-Mobile's price lock will only reimburse your last bill if you terminate service due to a price increase.
Another happy SafeLight customer.
SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace.
There I was driving down the highway when out of nowhere, a rock hits my windshield. Ah, so annoying. But then I remembered SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace. I booked my appointment at SafeLight.com. And with my insurance, my new windshield was no cost to me. SafeLight even handled my insurance claim, which was the best.
Cracked windshield? Just go to SafeLight.com and let SafeLight take care of everything.
SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace.
Oh, I see you eyeballing your summer clothes and hoping to find a faster way to get into summer shape. Well, I got you. It's Randy West. There's an UGG way to lose fat and inches, and there's an easy way. The UGG way? Well, you hire a trainer, you starve yourself, you hit the gyms for hours on end, and you probably don't get results very fast. Or you do it the easy way, in a day. At Sono Bello, one visit, summer ready. Can you imagine? Sono Bello is the national leader at remarkable fat removing procedure. It's called micro laser fat removal. Say hello, summer, goodbye, fat and inches. Because in one visit, the muffin tops, tummy, thighs, the arm fat are gone and permanently. Sono Bello's spring savings event is on. You gotta hurry though. Schedule that free consultation and lose your mind at how affordable this is. And you can look great now and pay later. Visit SonoBello.com/radio. That's Sono, BELLO.com/radio. Again, SonoBello.com/radio.
Everything that you'd ever seen with Miranda Lambert on it, I have my finger on the pulse of what it is. Idlewind, I've seen every article of clothing. I've spent hours and hours sending inspirations. I've sent clothes that I love and fabrics, and I'm involved in every single garment that you see. It's important to me that it is an extension of my music and it's an extension of who I am. I always want it to stay as honest as my music.
Idlewind at Boot Barn.
Are you sick?
Yes, I've caught the travel bug. I need a vacation stat.
I heard Silver Airways has returned to PBI, flying nonstop to Pensacola, Tallahassee, Tampa, Nassau, and Marsh Harbor.
I heard that too. We can catch a flight to Pensacola to relax on the white sand beaches or Tallahassee to see the kids.
Wow.
What about Tampa? It's been too long since we've been to the theme parks there.
How could we choose just one?
Let's book all five.
Palm Beach International Airport is South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Book now at silverairways.com.
No way. Boiled Tropicana's open till midnight?
What? Grab me a Tropi Chop.
Done.
Ah, forgot the cheesy yuca bites.
Got it.
You're looking out, bro.
I didn't say they're for you, though.
Boiled Tropicana. Real food, real fresh, and now real late. Open till midnight. Hours may vary by location.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide with all the celebrity buzz. It's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex. But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
The school district of Palm Beach County is your best choice.
It's time to step into kindergarten. Parents, the school district of Palm Beach County is now enrolling kindergarten students for the upcoming school year. Register now at palmbeachschools.org/kindergarten. Find out when to attend your school's kindergarten roundup and how to get your free kindergarten readiness kit. That's palmbeachschools.org/kindergarten.
So, you finally have some time to yourself. Even if it is just the car ride home, it's you time. And look at you. Do not disturb set before you even got in the car? Impressive. You've earned this moment to just chill and drive. This break is brought to you by Target Zero and the Florida Department of Transportation.
Hey, it's Suits, and Wendy's has another sweet reason to get out of bed. Their new Cinnabon Pull Apart is here to satisfy your morning cravings with all the bakery-inspired flavors you love from Cinnabon, like sweet, warm cinnamon sugar rolled dough, the perfect ooey-gooey texture, and that signature cream cheese frosting. And now you can pair it with a small vanilla frosty cream cold brew for $5. Get the best part in every single bite when you choose wisely. Choose Wendy's new Cinnabon Pull Apart. Limited time only. U.S. price and participation may vary.
Injured in an accident? Visit Lytle Rider Smith Ivy and Fronrath at foryourrights.com.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Ow! There's a lot of dumbass criminals to talk about, baby. It's the whacked out news. People breaking the law. Ha ha, fighting in the noon. Ha, drunk people pooping in the street. Ha ha, it's the whacked out news. So many people on meth. Ow!
Well, another day and another crazy video and story about a Boeing 737. What in the heck, man? Did you see that Southwest flight that had to make an emergency landing right after takeoff in Denver after the engine cover blew off and hit the wing?
It's another Boeing, right?
Yeah, the same 737s, the ones that have been having the problems.
Oddly, that's the noise it makes when the parts fly off of it. Boing!
Boing!
Boing! Yeah.
Wow. Here you can check out the pilot talking about needing an emergency landing.
Let's go ahead and declare an emergency for Southwest 3695. And we'd like an immediate return. We got a piece of the engine cowling hanging off, apparently.
Southwest 3695, roger that. Turn left heading 190 to the Denver via radar vectors.
Left turn heading 190, Southwest 3695.
Unreal, right?
It really is.
What the heck, man?
It makes you think this has always been a problem, and it's just now getting reported.
I don't know. It feels a little different.
It feels a little different.
Yeah.
There's a lot of parts flying off these planes every week.
Well, and the fact that Boeing stock, Boeing CEOs, a lot of people have gone bye-bye, and yeah, I think it's a lot more than the norm.
So, is it sabotage? I mean, like, what the hell? This is a lot.
What do you think it is?
I think that however they're doing the assembly, it's somebody who is responsible for manufacturing and assembly. It is jacked up. It's not going the right way. Or it could just be how people or engineers are maintaining these aircraft. Either way, there is a major kink in the chain somewhere that they need to start looking at the chain and figuring out where that is. They got a bad link somewhere. And I assume that's what the new CEO is going to have to do, and fast. 49-year-old David Baker was a Florida Highway Patrol trooper, and then he decided to throw a cinder block through the window of a Hooters in Daytona Beach and steal 4 beer taps last week. He's no longer employed with the FHP.
What happened, dude?
I don't know.
Dude.
It's like the middle of the night. The guy just, I don't know. They got him on camera, too, loading items into his truck after he smashed through a large glass window at the restaurant. And they're like, yeah, that's him. I
Did
got
he
him
not
on video.
See the camera?
I don't know, man.
Maybe he was hammered.
What happened? Yeah, he caused an estimated $20,000 in damage, and now he is unemployed.
Dang.
Yeah. In October of 2023, Julia Rijon Moorhead was in the lobby at the Ben Hotel.
Her name's Moorhead.
Yes, in West Palm Beach, yes. It's a kind of an unfortunate name, is it not?
It is.
Yeah, she was claiming that she was trying to go upstairs to the room she shared with her boyfriend, but apparently at the Ben, they couldn't confirm that she actually had a room. Plus, she was pretty drunk and was falling down, so the staff of the Ben called 911 and said, yeah, this chick's kind of trespassing. The cops show up, and she did not handle it very well, and so she was ordered to leave, and Moorhead wasn't feeling that. And she became a little abusive, and it just really fell apart.
Oh boy.
Why are you surrounding me? Like, I've done nothing wrong. Why the f*** are you doing this to me?
No, you have to go outside.
What the f***? How do I f***ing die? So give me a f***ing break if I don't give a f***.
Okay,
ma'am.
Listen to me.
Back. Why? Listen. Wait, ma'am. No, excuse me. I'm sitting here.
No, no more.
So why? No more. Why? No more. Give me a f***ing reason.
They want you off.
This is my f***ing boyfriend, Red f***ing Jerry.
You need to get
she has to leave.
Excuse me.
Oh, oh, he hit me.
Oh. Jen! The f*** off of me! Jazz, off of me!
That's kind of a bad night.
some mistakes were made.
Yeah, kind of a bad night.
Wrestling with the cops never turns out well for you.
It is so funny. Yeah. They all say the same things in these drunk videos. When they're, I didn't do anything wrong. Why won't you tell me? Then they'll tell her what she's done wrong. I did nothing wrong. What? Tell me.
Like, we just told you.
We just told you. You're hammered. And you're proving our case.
That's going to be on YouTube.
Well, the good news is Julia Rajon Moorhead gets a return trip to Palm Beach County next Tuesday for her court date. So,
all right.
She's charged with trespass, disorderly intoxication, and resisting officer with violence.
Get him, Moorhead.
Mm-hmm.
Does Moorhead wake up the next morning and go, all right, I was out of line?
You're probably like, as you're walking it back, you at first you may try to still hang on and justify it, but yeah, I imagine after a while.
Well,
like,
I wonder if Moorhead remembers. Because if you wake up and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm in a holding cell, what happened?
Yes.
Yeah, you start to piece it together and you're like, uh-oh.
The video will be helpful for Moorhead.
Oh, yeah.
But does she remember any of it or not? Like, what would she say today when maybe she's sober?
Yeah.
Now, that's the person I want to talk to.
More trouble at a hotel, but this one actually might be on the hotel. Lavelle Jackson says he stayed at the Mandalay Bay in Las Vegas, and the staff used his toothbrush to clean the bathroom.
Mandalay Bay.
Yeah, okay, Mandalay Bay.
How does he know they used his toothbrush?
He explains.
So whatever you do, if you stay in that Mandalay Bay, from now on, any hotel, I will no longer be leaving my toothbrush out. And they use my toothbrush to clean. And they're being nasty to me about it. And they want to offer me a $50 credit and, what did they say, a new toothbrush. They use my toothbrush to clean. And they want to give me a $50 credit and a new toothbrush.
He says as soon as it hit his mouth, he yanked it out. The brushes were just crazy soft. All outside brushes were pushed out. The inside brushes were all over the place. It was very obvious.
Oh.
So I don't know.
How could you prove that?
That's the thing.
You would have to have set up a hidden camera, which is not hard to do. I can get Rocco on this.
Okay.
He loves a hidden camera.
Because on both ends, I mean, I'm not saying it didn't happen, but anybody could make that up.
Sure.
And say, look what they did, guys.
But if you have video of that sort of thing happening to your toothbrush, I think you have a really good case against the Mandalay Bay.
Yeah. Apparently, they actually caught this guy in the act. They don't have to. It's not a he said, she said. A 56-year-old man in Japan got arrested after allegedly rubbing his buttocks against a water tap.
Dude, man, people just, they're weird, man.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
People just do a weird thing, and you don't know what's going on. I'm sure you've drank something or have eaten something or where someone's rubbed their butt on
I've definitely brushed my teeth with toilet toothbrush. Definitely.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and a 51-year-old man in Ireland appeared in court completely nude and refused to wear clothes after his emotional support cat went missing during a traffic stop.
Oh, bless his heart. That's a lot going on. There.
That is a lie. He's looking for his emotional support cat. Aww. And 42 million people felt the 4.8 earthquake that hit the East Coast on Friday, including a 33-year-old dad near Philly who was getting a vasectomy when it happened.
Oh, no. You do not want to shake that surgeon.
Oh, my goodness. No.
That's kind of a scary thing to think about. Now you never think.
Nobody needs to shake the guy with your testicles in his hand.
What a terrible time for an earthquake to hit.
It really is. The worst.
Luckily, he is okay, and he's not going to ever have kids again, but I think that actually was a design, so luckily that is all right. All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes. Oh, man, we talked to our friend Linh on Friday about how she did the 23andMe and had a matchup with somebody that is supposedly her half-brother. And coincidentally, even though she was born in Vietnam and adopted there, they both wound up in the United States and in the state of Florida. And we're going to meet in Orlando over the weekend. How did it go down? You're going to find out coming up.
More KVJ next on 87.9 WRMF.
So you just used bug spray in your home. Now what? Well, between the waiting and waiting for things to dry up, and keeping your family away from the mess, it hits you. You could have used Zevo. Unlike other bug sprays that stick around, Zevo goes from kill to clean in seconds. Plus, it's safe for use around people and pets when used as directed. Zevo, people friendly, bug deadly.
Strax Aesthetics, leader in cosmetic surgery for 20 years, offering the same great values with prestigious board-certified surgeons. For qualified patients, breast augs from $100 per month, tummy tucks from $155 per month. Great credit is not a necessity. Meet your actual surgeon in a face-to-face consultation. Gastric sleeves at the guaranteed lowest prices. Semaglutide for weight loss at 50% below other clinics' prices. Strax MedSpa will beat any advertised price on products. Liquid facelifts with no downtime at highly affordable prices. For information, call 954-744. Or visit StraxPlastics.com.
The Cooling Advisors team, they are there for you. Whenever your AC has issue, call them. They jump when you call. Cooling Advisors explained it to me like, look, when someone calls us, it's an AC emergency. And we jump into action because we don't want them to go a single day without AC. And I was like, yeah, that makes sense. It's South Florida. We can't go a single hour without AC. Cooling Advisors wants to be your partner. Call them up. Find out about the Cooling Club, where you can get regular service, regular tune-ups, regular maintenance on your equipment to not just save you money, but save your system. You know, you save thousands of dollars in energy costs over the years, and keeping up with your system gets you a longer life out of that system. We love that, and that's why we love the Cooling Club. Go online today, coolingadvisors.com.
Want your child to go to summer camp, but afraid you can't afford it? Did you know you can apply for one of the more than 3,000 summer camp scholarships available right now for Palm Beach County children? Now is the time to apply for camp scholarships. The deadline is April 12th. To learn more, go to everyparentpbc.org/camp. That's everyparentpbc.org/camp. This message brought to you by Children's Services Council of Palm Beach County.
Hey, it's Suits, and Wendy's has another sweet reason to get out of bed. Their new Cinnabon Pull-Apart is here to satisfy your morning cravings with all the bakery-inspired flavors you love from Cinnabon, like sweet, warm cinnamon sugar rolled dough, the perfect ooey-gooey texture, and that signature cream cheese frosting. And now you can pair it with a small vanilla frosty cream cold brew for $5. Get the best part in every single bite when you choose wisely. Choose Wendy's new Cinnabon Pull Apart. Limited time only. U.S. price and participation may vary.
Probably never really thought a lot about heart disease, but you really should. Did you know that 1 out of 3 people are going to die from heart disease in America? And in 30 to 40% of the heart attacks, the first symptom is sudden death. And we're not talking about the person you look at and be like, oh, they're a walking heart attack. You don't know. There are people that are physically fit that have gone into Life Imaging FLA, and they look at their heart and they say, you need to get right to the hospital. And they've saved their life because early detection does. And they're offering up a free heart scan with just a few minimum requirements, a $699 value, where you can find out if you're good or not. Why would you not do this? It's free. It takes 10 minutes. There's no dyes. There's no need to even undress. And it's not just your heart. They can do a cancer screening or a virtual colonography. Are you a big fan of sedation? I know I'm not. This is why I am going right here to Life Imaging FLA when I need scan. And you can get yours right now from your cell. Call #250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's #250, keyword free heart scan.
Music this hour.
Sponsored by Stormtight Windows.
Brace yourselves. Stormtight has a deal that will blow you away. We're raining down savings with 50% off installation of all new windows. That's extreme savings on extreme weather protection. Visit us online and lock down these savings today. Go to stormtightwindows.com.
Be a part of the show. Mail at kvjshow.com or send us a message on the 97.9 WRMF app. Or just pick up the phone and call us. 877-979-WRMF. Now, back to the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
An unbelievable story. We heard the first part on Friday. Our good friend and KVJ Nationer, Linh, was telling about how she used 23andMe because she was adopted and wanted to know medically if she had anybody that could be a relative to let her know about things that might come up. Well, when she did that, she got a ping and found out that she has a half-brother that not only was born in Vietnam like she was, wound up in the orphanage system, but then wound up in the United States and in the state of Florida.
Crazy.
It was a crazy story, and here is what we heard from Linh on Friday.
The only thing I know is that I was in an orphanage in Vietnam. I was born during the war. I was adopted when I was 3. That's all I knew. And then fast forward, I took a DNA test. I did 23andMe, finally. And lo and behold, I got a ping. I was in shock. I was in denial. I just got a message from the half-brother. And it was just, it's crazy. So he reached out to me, and he just said, you know, it looks like we have the same mother, because he kind of looked at the profile, and we just started talking from there. We haven't spoken in via phone or in person yet, just texting.
Okay. It's pretty exciting, though, huh?
So exciting.
Yeah, very exciting. So she's got that part down. They then connected, and they made plans to meet over the weekend in Orlando. We said, well, we definitely have to talk to you on Monday to find out what you discovered, how it went. Did you click? She went, and she has got the update for us. What happened over the weekend next, right here on the KVJ show.
Once the flight had flown with the wilt of the rose, I slept all alone, but you still wouldn't go. Let's fast forward to 300 takeout coffees later. I see your profile and your smile on unsuspecting waiters. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every maiden's bed for something greater. Baby, was it over when she laid down on your couch? Was it over when he unbuttoned my blouse? Come here, I whispered in your ear, and your dream as you passed out. Baby, was it over then? Is it over now? When you lost control, red blood, white snow, blue dress on a bow. New girl is my clone. Did you think I didn't see there were flashing lights? At least I had the decency to keep my nights out of sight. Only rumors about my hips and thighs and my whispered sighs. Oh Lord, I think about jumping off of very tall somethings just to see you come running and say the one thing I've been wanting. But no, let's fast forward to 300 awkward blind dates later. If she's got blue eyes, I will surmise that she'll probably date her. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every model's bed for something greater. Baby, was it over when she laid down on your couch? Was it over when he unbuttoned my blouse? Come here, I whispered in your ear in your dream as you passed out. Baby, was it over then? And is it over now? Ah. Ah. I think I didn't see. There were flashing lights. At least I had the decency to keep my nights out of sight. Only rumbles from my hips and thighs and I whispered sighs. Oh Lord, I think about jumping off of fairy tale somethings just to see you come running, running, and say the one thing I've been wanting. But no.
We gave out that first clue for you to win Taylor Swift tickets when she comes to Hard Rock Stadium Saturday, October 19th. You got to decode the friendship bracelet. Those clues happen every weekday at 9, 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m. But when we do it at 9, that's it. That's it, baby. That clue's gone.
Chambert said the clue was easy.
Oh, he did. Okay. He's already got it solved.
He said he's on it.
Okay, well, that's what you got to do. You've got to solve the phrase that is on the friendship bracelet. When you get it, take it into the WRMF app and enter it. There's some other clues in there as well.
But I kind of got that Swifty mind, so I'm not shocked that I did this.
Okay. Got it. All right, well, just a second ago, we heard about Linh from Friday. She was telling us about how she was adopted, wound up in an orphanage in Vietnam, and then in the United States and Florida. Does a 23andMe, pings that she's got a half-brother, and guess what? He's in Orlando.
What the heck?
They were supposed to meet up over the weekend, and the big question for Linh, how did it go?
Oh, my gosh, it was amazing. So my kids went with me, which is super nice. They got to meet my brother. It was wonderful because you don't know what to expect. You don't know what kind of emotions are going to be there. I tried to be cool. But as soon as I saw him, we just gave each other a big hug. And, you know, he told me when he hugged me that it was probably hard for me being by myself. And after everything we went through, that he at least had a sister that he was adopted with. So it was really cool that he recognized that, because I didn't realize that it was hard for me in any way until you realized that you did. You went through that alone. He actually has a picture of my mother and my father that my mother had given him to give to his adoptive father. And he was instrumental in clearing the orphanages and bringing people over. And I mean, that's just crazy in and of itself. Go ahead and do 23andMe. You'll never know what you'll find.
Wow.
Wow.
How crazy is that's
that, huh? Amazing.
She's getting a photo of her own parents out of the whole thing, too.
Yeah, they have a different dad.
Yep.
And so his dad was, like, amazing in helping clear the orphanages. Mm-hmm. He's actually American.
Okay.
Isn't that crazy? But Linh's parents are both Vietnamese. And okay. She was in a different orphanage from her brother.
Oh, wow.
And then they both end up in Florida.
Yeah. That's just, wow, what a nutty world it is, huh?
And now Linh got to go up on the Bright Line this weekend.
Yeah.
Brought her two kids that she adopted.
Yeah.
So she's an adoptive mother now, and they got to go up there and meet their uncle.
It's a great, I mean, one, it's awesome finding family you didn't know you had, the adoption process, which is absolutely amazing. It's a great story for that. But could you imagine going this far in your life thinking it was you, and then you find out that it's not? For me, I'm an only child. Like, it would, I don't even know that I could process it. Be like, wait a minute, there's another genetic version of me out there. I've got an actual biological sibling. Crazy. That's a nutty concept.
It's amazing, though. I'm so happy for her. And now this whole new beautiful family, she's going to be getting to know him and all of his family and have this whole new connection.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing.
It is. I'm wondering, when you actually keep track of all the 23andMe stories, how many are happy, how many are not?
I think...
What is the win-loss rate? And not to say you ever regret, but you find out some things, you're going, oh my gosh, this isn't as pretty as Linh's story.
I think it happens quite a bit. Yeah, they're not all happy stories.
Well, a lot of them are like infidelities.
Yes.
Sure, yeah, and probably then, a lot of surprises, curveballs, broken families.
Your daddy's not your daddy.
Hers is a united family you didn't know. Many of them are like, oh my gosh, the family's over and we're split forever.
The man that raised you isn't your dad, and he didn't know, and neither did you.
And you find out at age 25, you're like, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
Mm-hmm. Well, we got another update for you as well. I know a lot of people were asking questions about suits and his situation here. He is like so many other Floridians. You just honestly can't even say Floridians, man. It's just it's people. It's global. It's American. It is definitely South Floridian. It is just the struggles in making ends meet and how expensive rent and everything else is. And so it has been an ongoing struggle for Suits, and we're going to find out where his status is. He was searching for jobs last we'd heard, and we'll see where he is with all that next.
97.9 WRMF wants to get you into Taylor Swift's The Eras Tour in Miami. Ooh, You've got to decode the friendship bracelets to get your entry. That's right, Swifties. We know you love an Easter egg, and this is your chance to prove you're a Taylor Swift mastermind. Your mission is to listen each weekday at 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 1, 3, and 5 p.m. for the clues to decode the friendship bracelet of the day to get your entry. But you'll need to be quick and follow along to win. Decode, leading up to the release of her new album on April 19th. Get rules and contest info at WRMF.com. And psst, maybe a few hints are inside our mobile app.
In West Palm, the only thing we like better than sunshine is savings. And with unlimited welcome for Verizon, you can get the best deals, even if you're on a single line. For a limited time, single lines start at just $50 a month when you bring your own phone, with auto pay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $15 a month. And when you switch now, you can save on the things you love, like Netflix and Max, all on the most awarded 5G network. Now that's savings easier than a day at the beach. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. But this offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. $180 BYOD promo credit and $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months. For new customers with one new line with your own 4G or 5G phone on unlimited welcome plan required. Additional terms apply. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. In times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds. $10 a month for each My Plan perk. Additional terms and conditions apply per perk.
Are you sick?
Yes, I've caught the travel bug. I need a vacation stat.
I heard Silver Airways has returned to PBI, flying nonstop to Pensacola, Tallahassee, Tampa, Nassau, and Marsh Harbor.
I heard that too. We can catch a flight to Pensacola to relax on the white sand beaches or Tallahassee to see the kids.
Wow.
What about Tampa? It's been too long since we've been to the theme parks there.
How could we choose just one?
Let's book all five.
Palm Beach International Airport is South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Book now at silverairways.com.
You want a sub freshly sliced to order? You go to Jersey Mike's. You want the perfect radio idea? You go to me. Like this. I'm a lone ninja warrior. By night, I glide unseen across the rooftops, watching my enemies from the shadows. By day, I go to Jersey Mike's, watching someone freshly slice my sub. My blade is called Shadow. His blade is a Bezerba brand meat slicer. Clearly, I have much to learn about this land. Freshly sliced just for you. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
I love the inventory at Greenway Kia. I've driven all the cars. I feel like I went to the University of Kia because I really did get the full immersive experience. And I got to tell you, if you think Kias are like discount, like first cars, no, these new Kias are completely technologically advanced. They have tricked them out, redesigned them. They got one of those German engineers from Audi, and he changed everything about the Kia brand. If you think you know Kia, but you haven't driven one, you really need to go drive one, because I was in the same boat. I thought I knew it. I was so wrong. The hybrids, the Tellurides, the EVs, the Sportages, the K5s, the Fortes, the Sorentos, they've got them all. And at Greenway Kia, they're doing construction. So they've got to get these cars out of the way. That means you save. If you're making $350 a week, they want to approve you. Call 1-800-NEW-KIAS or go to KiaWestPalmBeach.com.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
A true partner in your health dedicates time to understanding your needs. At Conviva Care Center, doctors make one-on-one time with you a priority, so you can get all your questions answered and feel more confident in your healthcare. Conviva Senior Care experts have been helping seniors stay healthy and independent for more than 50 years. Schedule a tour today at tourconviva.com. That's tourconviva.com.
If you're unaware, T-Mobile calls themselves the Un-carrier, which is fitting considering they just unraveled their price lock guarantee for new customers. If you ask me, that's pretty uncool. If you're uncomfortable with a company that says one thing but does another, then switch to Xfinity, whose whole home Wi-Fi, wired internet, service, speed, and reliability are unparalleled. Unjoin the Un-carrier. Switch to Xfinity today. Now through April 21st, new customers can get 300 megabits per second Xfinity Internet for $35. And ask how you can save 40% over T-Mobile in your first year. Switch today. Go to Xfinity.com/TMOFAX, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account and a 1-year contract. Connect more internet versus T-Mobile home internet. $60 a month. Regular pricing applies after promo period. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Effective for new customers after 1/17/2024. T-Mobile's price lock will only reimburse your last bill if you terminate service due to a price increase.
Another happy SafeLight customer.
SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace.
There I was driving down the highway when out of nowhere, a rock hits my windshield. Ah, so annoying. But then I remembered, SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace. I booked my appointment at SafeLight.com. And with my insurance, my new windshield was no cost to me. SafeLight even handled my insurance claim, which was the best.
Cracked windshield? Just go to SafeLight.com and let SafeLight take care of everything.
SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace.
When you do what I did, you're just going to have peace of mind going into hurricane season. Hey, it's Virginia. You know, I fortified my home. Finally, I got the project done. It took me 3 years to do it. But that's the great thing about BNT Windows and Doors. I didn't have all the money up front. They let me break it up into phases. That made it easier on the budget. And now, here we are, completely fortified. And this will be my second hurricane season without the fear of a window is going to blow out in a storm. I've done everything I can. I have prepared my home. I have done the best by my family and my things and my home. Do it with BNT like I did. BNT is so on point. Master installers. They use that custom PGT product, and PGT just makes the best-selling window and door on the market. So you've got the best installers from BNT, and then you've got this fantastic window from PGT. Go online today. BNTWindowsAndDoors.com.
Experience the Anna Jar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
Wait, KVJ is on TikTok?
Oh, you've got to see this.
Now, back to the KVJ show on 97.9 WRMF.
Well, we got another update here for you. You probably heard last week, I think it was, or the week before, when Suits was on a little venture out searching to see what other kind of profession he might get himself into. Suits has been with us for many, many years now, and like many situations since the pandemic, there is just a tough economy that is going around, and it has been very tough on radio as well. I know that our company has done what they can to try to survive and make things happen. Many radio companies have cut a lot of positions, and it is really a tightening of the belt, and that has been tough. And this is not necessarily a new situation. It's something that we've been trying to remedy for years, trying to find little extras and things for Suits to do. And there's been assistance from KVJ show members, and KVJ Nation has stepped up. And, you know, it just, as time has gone on, Suits, you kind of have a unique situation because it's not just necessarily you. You got your mom with you as well.
Yep.
So, you know, it's not just the standard fare that I know a lot of people think this is a very easy fix. And look, there are so many people we're talking to that are struggling and trying to find ways to make ends meet and what they're doing. And, you know, so because of where we are now, you have been looking at what other options might be out there as we continue to try to pursue some remedies to keep you here and not lose you. But you know, you're at that point where I just got to see what else it might be, because, you know, we are in a industry that is right now, unfortunately, it's reducing.
It's downsizing considerably.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, we are not going in the direction that we would like with wealth opportunities. So in other industries, there are some positions that you have found interesting, and you were looking at working on the railroad.
I know, right? That's completely random. Everybody I tell it to, I'm like, so here, let me lead you down my thought process and how I got here. But, you know, last week I kind of talked about how I had an interest in being an airline pilot. And through that process, mm-hmm. it was very, very expensive. And just with the situation I'm in right now, getting those loans and being able to pay that back just wasn't on the table. Wasn't able to make it happen. So I started looking at jobs where I could just learn a skill on the job and have a really good future where there's good earnings potential, there's growth potential, and set myself up for retirement. It's never too early to start thinking about that. So I was really surprised how lucrative a career can be if you work your way into a locomotive engineer. And you start out in some lower positions that still pay pretty decently. Like a conductor on the railroad makes fairly good money, and they've got great retirement benefits. They've got a pension. They've got their own, like, you don't do Social Security. They got their own thing that pays more than Social Security.
Wow. Are they hiring?
Seriously, yeah, come on. I'll take you guys all with me.
We could do the morning show, and then we could go work on the Bright Line.
Yeah.
That's great. Good
so,
idea.
Honestly, I was like, you know, this actually, it sounds like an interesting opportunity. It's something different. You get to interact with a lot of people on a daily basis, and they train you while they pay you. And it doesn't start out paying too bad. So I literally went down and I just started applying. I Googled every railroad I could find and just said, let me give this a shot, see if there's entry-level positions, applied to a bunch of them. And I had opportunities present with five different companies.
Wow.
And I'm looking at three right now. So I have two interviews that I still have to do, and I did an interview for one of them. And it's going to be interesting, you know, because it's a completely different thing from what I've done. The goal is really just career stability and being able to make sure I don't have this struggle I've been in, you know? It's tough to live that way. My goal really is just to get myself into a position where the bills are paid. I don't have to worry about that. And then I can enjoy my free time off from work. And this seems like a path to do that.
And you don't have to let the dream die about being a pilot either. With more money, you can put that away for pilot's lessons.
Absolutely.
And still, that can still be a dream that comes to fruition one of these days.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you're not into it, you know, a few years later, you can always make a change, you know?
Totally.
So, but I'm actually really excited about the opportunity. I think it's going to be something fun and different.
A lot of the remedies we've been coming up with are just kind of putting a Band-Aid on the cut. And for a long-term solution for you to, like you're saying, it's a good opportunity.
Yeah, and that's just the big thing. You know, you guys have found a lot of ways to extend this further than I think I expected I would be able to stay down here. And it's really been because of not only KVJ Nation's suggestions, but the help of you guys. I don't think people behind the scenes really realize how much you guys have helped me over the last 2 years, really, to keep things afloat. So, you know, at a certain point, though, you got to start saying, how can I fix this and how can I do this in a long term, like you're saying, Bird? Yeah. And this seems like an opportunity to do that. So it's something very different, something I never expected I would be doing. But the closer I get to this opportunity becoming a reality, I'm kind of excited for it, you know?
Yeah.
You love travel. Mm-hmm. You love seeing new places.
Yeah. I honestly, and the cool thing, honestly, you know, look, being born and raised in Florida, it's going to be weird leaving Florida. But my opportunities that are presenting put me into some more of like a city living space. You know, I've got opportunities to be in the Northeast right now. And it would be kind of interesting to live that lifestyle because I have never lived that lifestyle. So there's kind of an excitement for that, too.
You said you might not need a car?
Yeah, definitely. Well, transportation's so easy to get up there, and if you work for them, then you don't have to pay for it.
Wow.
So that's kind of a nice plus.
We just want you to do, you know, we want you to be successful, and we want you to be comfortable.
And happy.
And happy.
Happy is the most important.
Mm-hmm. So you're going to be out tomorrow doing another interview, and then you'll have an update, I assume, when you get back from that.
Yeah, so I'm flying out of Palm Beach International tonight. I'm going to be flying into Newark, and then I've got two interviews tomorrow.
Nice.
And that will wrap up for those three positions. And hopefully, you know, I know the first thing people have been sending me, a lot of information on state taxes and stuff like that. I did look into that. I'm not going to be surprised by state taxes. And I made sure that the income level that they're offering with state taxes and everything is doable. And it's all workable there. So
good.
I feel like each of them are a good opportunity. My preference is to get to whatever one's the lowest possible
on
taxes, but it just depends on what works out. If I get any of those three, I'll be pretty happy.
Cool.
And they already seem interested in you.
Yes.
Yay.
The first interview went really well, and then I had to go do testing for the other ones. They make you test beforehand, then that went really well too. And
I see you testing well.
You're going to be awesome with whatever you decide to do, and I'm very excited for
it. Amen.
Because we really do love you.
We do love you, and this is not goodbye. This is just, look, we're going to make alternate things happen for the next little bit and then see when we can get back together.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Get myself in that position.
It would have got weird if you and your mom would have stayed at my house. I think I would have rooted y'all out. Long term, I don't think it was the right
thing. Jay Bird was ready to move you and your mom in.
The offer was always there. My mom, I don't think she was really expecting what was going to come of that, but we were ready to do it if we had to. You do not understand the Bird.
Yeah, your mom wasn't ready for the Bird.
All right, man. Well, best of luck. Well, you'll be out Tuesday, hopefully back with us on Wednesday then, and we'll let people know what's going on with it.
But I'll keep you all posted.
Thank you.
No problem.
All right, coming up here in a couple minutes, if you need a little dose of positivity in your Monday, Bird is going to be dropping that thought for the day on you next.
For a while there, it was rough.
rough, but lately I've been doing better than the last four cold Decembers I recall. And I see my family every month. I found a girl my parents love. She'll come and stay the night, and I think I might have it all. And I thank God every day for the girl he sent my way. But I know the things he gives me, he can take away. And I hold you every night, and that's a feeling I wanna get used to. But there's no man as terrified as the man who stands to lose you. Oh, I hope I don't lose you. Please stay. I want you, I need you, oh God, don't take these beautiful things that I've got. Please stay. I want you, I need you, oh God, don't take these beautiful things that I've got. I found my mind, I'm feeling sane. It's been a while, but I'm finding my faith. If everything's good and it's great, why do I sit and wait till it's gone? Oh, I tell you, I know I've got enough. I've got peace and I've got love. But I'm up and I'm thinking I just might lose it all. You, I need you, oh God. I need these beautiful things that I've got.
Oh, everybody's going gonzo for that big old eclipse happening today.
I am. I got bit
you're,
by the
you're
bug.
In it. You're in it. You're in it.
Well, okay. We just found out that at the Lake Park Library, a place where little baby Jaybird spent time, They're giving out free glasses.
Yeah, there's a couple places that are, if you know where to go. There's some libraries especially, and most of your municipalities are going to have some stuff. The science centers as well are going to have stuff.
The smart of the libraries. They don't want you to look at the sun and burn your eyes out.
Yeah. So I just put the glasses on, chill in my backyard, and look up.
Yeah.
That's pretty much it. Yeah. That's pretty much what you're looking at. The event begins at 1:48 p.m.
Right. Don't miss it, Bird.
You've got a maximum eclipse of only 6 minutes and 6 seconds, and that's going to be right around the peak of 3:03 p.m. In South Florida, we'll see a partial eclipse where 49% of the sun will be obscured by the moon for 2 hours and 26 minutes. So it'll look a little weird and kind of murky, I guess.
I mean, Is this not going to be as cool as I think it's going to be? I'm going to be disappointed in this.
Look, you're going to be having FOMO if you don't at least experience a couple minutes of it. If you go out and you're like, it's not that big of a deal, at least you tried it.
I agree.
You can't, don't take a nap and sleep through it because it's going to be peaceful and dark.
Mm-hmm. I wish I could take a nap.
And if today had any kind of soundtrack, I think you know what the song would be, right?
One time I was falling in love. Now I'm only falling apart. There's nothing I can do. A total eclipse of the heart.
Oh yeah, Bonnie Tyler from back in the day. 40 years ago, man.
Once upon a time there was light in my life, but now there's only love in the dark. Nothing I can say.
I'm sorry, that song still slaps.
It does.
I think it's over 3 minutes into this song, and there's another 3 minutes of She does it again. And I love the theatrical thing.
Yeah.
The best was when we sang it in cocktails and karaoke and we sang Turn Around Beady Eyes.
Mm. I'm sure it was great for Kevin. I'm sure he loved it.
The crowd.
The public
loved
ridicule.
It.
Yeah. It's fun.
Let's go on stage with microphones.
When everyone's kind of laughing at you and you're the joke. Yeah.
That's why Kevin's not excited for the Snack Pack show. Right? I'd bring him up on his battle rap. I mean, just be standing there. He's like, it's kind of odd. I don't feel good.
Bonnie Tyler apparently gets a nice little bump in money every time there's an eclipse. In 2017, she was on a cruise ship with DNCE performing that song, got money from that. And she said that every time there is an eclipse, the searches for her number one single go up by nearly 50%.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah. And here's the thing that was crazy. That song now 4 decades old, and her net worth, $30 million.
Wow.
Good for her.
She's made some bank off that song.
I think she's big in one country specifically.
Maybe, and they're paying her some money. And the odd little fun fact about that song, it was originally supposed to be done by Meatloaf. Which, can't you hear that being a Meatloaf song?
Without a doubt.
He lost his voice the day he was supposed to record it, and
Dang.
It went to her.
Dang, what a great behind the music.
Yep.
And the guy that Air Supply did a song, Making Love Out of Nothing at All, and I think it's done by the same guy.
I was going to say, there's similarities in both. Yeah, so fun stuff for your eclipse day today. Bird, if you would, get us to the after the show with your thought.
Life is about change. Sometimes it's painful, sometimes it's beautiful, but most of the time, it's both.
Dang. That's a good one.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.